All right, Carl?
Yeah.
Bit miserable today, Carl. Let me explain why.
Go on.
Steve, and to you, the listeners. Well, we came in to a big, big bunch of stuff. Dropped off by, was it Becky from Marks and Spencer? Just like lovely stuff. Food, presents for the cat, books, just, you know, to Ricky and Steve. Ricky and Steve. Ricky and Steve, who do the show. Right? Ricky Gervais and Steve Merchant.
GQ presenters of the year.
Creators of The Office, yeah. Right?
Award winning.
Carl's looking over, I go, oh, so, well, maybe, oh, it's not just, not for you, no. And then he told me why he's grumpy anyway.
Go on.
Do you know what XFM are giving everyone? He's been, how long have you been here?
About 6 years.
What are you getting for Christmas from XFM?
2 CDs.
Is that of your choice, or do they choose them?
There's a list of about 30.
Right.
Tell him what you chose.
30 CDs. I've gone for, Kings of Leon album.
Yeah.
And, The Best of Bob Marley.
Haven't we, like, given them away in the past or something? Or you could have burnt them off, couldn't you? You could have done copies. Illegal, but you could have done that.
Mm.
Anytime you wanted.
I don't think Bob Marley minds if you
no.
Bootleg his CDs.
It's out of order, though, isn't it?
It is bad.
Although you
is that always the case? Is it always been the truth of all the time you've been here?
No, it has been better than this.
Yeah, although you do get paid quite well and you do have an easy time.
Yeah, but don't give him the CDs then. If it was a milkman, you don't go, oh, I have 2 bottles of semi-skimmed. Happy Christmas.
Yeah. That is a valid point.
Do you know what I mean?
Are you complaining? Who is it who made this decision?
There's no point. No point, is there?
Why?
Just no point. I don't like moaning anyway, just...
Has it come from up top? Is it like from the capital people?
Just everyone, that's what everyone gets.
Yeah.
Yeah, but, oh no, will Christian get 2 CDs for getting up at 4:30 every day for about 5 years?
And keeping this station afloat.
Mm, probably.
Yeah.
So, that's why I'm a bit fed up.
What are you listening to first, Marley or Leon?
Well, yeah, the bit of, yeah, a bit of Marley.
I'll tell you what Marley's good for, as well. You're going to have a little beach holiday, aren't you, over Christmas, going to Lanzarote?
Mm.
Listening to that on the beach, you'll realise how wise XFM are in the long run. You know, you go, well, look, they could have given me 400 quid, right? Well, I'd have spent that. But this is, you know, the legend lives on.
It keeps on giving.
So, you're probably, you know what I mean? Think how much those, what you got to think of is how much those, all these great songs took, not only from the depth of his soul and, you know, all his sort of angst and knowledge and love, and then all the studio time, the marketing, and you're, they're just giving you one that. They go, don't worry about that, Carl, just have it. And you go, what? But all the time we spent doing with Bob Marley and everything, there. You know, have it, Carl.
And practice.
Yeah, have that. Thanks, well done. Carry on. We're still gonna pay you for the work.
Yeah.
That's just something on top.
Here's a little piece of Bob, free.
Yeah, so don't moan, it's extra. So, I didn't have to give you it at all. Play a record, you ungrateful little swine. In the week, I called Carl up. Said, how are you, mate? You went, not too bad. Now, as you know, his girlfriend's been away for ages, hasn't she?
Yeah.
Covering the World Cup, the
African Nations Cup.
She's a sports journalist.
Well, yeah.
All right.
Okay. I love the fact you're thinking, what does that mean? Like, well, she's not much of a journalist, Rick, to be honest. Well, I've read some of her stuff.
No, but she's not on air. She does stuff, you know.
Yeah.
Behind the scenes.
Yeah.
Sure.
A lot of journalists do. You always want to make clear that you're not going out with Kate Adie. That's what you want to make clear, isn't it? Yeah. Now, so she'd seen none of the meteoric rise of Carl as
right,
a broadcaster.
She's been away for the whole time.
A raconteur,
become,
a wit.
Yeah.
A cult figure, oh, to be honest. And he hadn't told her this. So, apparently he went home and she was sitting there looking a bit grumpy. He went, all right, so yeah. She went, should we go out then? She went, I'm not sure I want to go out with an idiot. Right?
Oh no!
Yeah. Because, and she went, Loch Ness Monster. Why don't you just think? Of course the Loch Ness Monster lives in Loch Ness. And she was giving a bit of a hard time. And she went, that's why I don't, he said, that's why I didn't tell her. I didn't tell her really. Same thing happened when I was at school and I had to play drums in Little Donkey. I didn't tell my parents, right? But my dad turned up anyway. And what happened?
He,
how old were you, Carl?
Well, it was the school that I used to go to.
Oh, yeah.
Like, oh, yeah. So you used to go to the school you used to go to?
No, but what I mean is, I didn't go to secondary, did I? So I missed a lot of that.
Sure.
But primary, I liked.
Oh,
it was all colouring in and stuff.
Yep.
And, it was a Christmas play. And I managed to get a part in it. And,
did you audition?
No. Got a part in it. And I should have been playing the drums to, the one about Kings.
We Three Kings.
Yeah. I was meant to be doing that. but Little Donkey came on, and it was one of those.
What do you mean came on?
That was like next up on you know the next song.
Right, right.
And it's one of them songs that you can't help sort of
tapping along to.
Yeah. Do you know like if I was to go
Yeah, you'd have to finish it with.
Yeah. Do you know that they actually send that into space?
Do they?
And
what, hoping the aliens will respond with that?
Yeah. They do that. Because apparently it is one of the things that you can't help.
What, even if you're an alien life form?
Yeah.
They know that, do they? Yeah.
But anyway.
What, because they watch Star Trek or something?
Hello. Knock, knock.
Yeah.
No, seriously.
Who's your dream? Like, if you send out knock, knock into space, yeah, they have to say.
Oggy, oggy, oggy.
Yeah.
Ah, oh, that is great.
Seriously.
Oh, hold on, was something out there? Was it a little green fellow? That is great.
Yeah, so anyway, that is Little Donkey is like one of them tunes that you can't, and I was there and I had the drumstick and I thought, oh God.
The drumstick!
I could feel myself, and anyway.
Just wanting to do it, yeah.
I started going along and playing Little Donkey, which I wasn't meant to do, but it went down such a storm.
What, were there people like parents and that dozing off, and then suddenly they heard your version of Little Donkey and they thought, wait a minute, now it's really picking up.
What do you mean?
I'm glad we paid £1.50 for this.
What do you mean it went down such a storm? I'm going, hold on, was it like when
people
Ringo,
have lighters in the air?
It was like when Ringo joined the Beatles and they were going, boo, Pete Best, but he went,
yeah,
they went, whoa! Oh, God.
No, but the teacher just said, oh, it went down really well, you can do that again tonight.
Right.
When you're in it again. But anyway, so my dad was there. And,
and you hadn't told him about this performance, so he just turned up off his own back.
I never took the letters home and stuff to show my mum and dad, because it just put me off. So, anyway, he turned up, don't know why, he must have heard from someone else's dad.
Yeah.
He turned up, and he swore about me, which...
Did he?
I don't...
Can you, what, could you use you a word that...
Is it allowed to be said? The word?
Of course it is.
Right. If you got a kid in the car or anything, you can turn it down now.
Yeah.
Right? But he said... there was a guy stood next to him with a camera, big video camera filming it. And he said, yeah, film it, but try and avoid getting the twat in the hat in the shot. Because I had one of those porters, you know, the little round pork pie hats on.
Right.
This is so what, sad.
What, was this a nativity play?
It was about Jesus and stuff.
Yeah, well, there was a porter there helping him with his bags.
Of course
there
was, I forgot.
I mean, Mary and Joseph, they got there. Yeah, yeah, because it was the hope, you know, because the inn was full. Yeah. But I think the porter doubled up with the inn and the stable.
Right, that was nice.
So he,
carry bags over, yeah.
Yeah, no, so you, yeah, yeah.
You're right, though. I don't know why I was wearing one of them. But I was, and,
And your father said that, and how did you know your father said that? Did you hear
him? About it later.
Oh, I told you about it later.
Yeah, I was talking about stuff I'd done at school, and he said, oh, God, remember that, and I spoke to him the other day about it.
Right.
And, yeah.
Oh, God. So that was the end of your sort of drumming career, really, because it could have been, I mean, you know, the audience loved it the night before.
Yeah.
You could have, like, been, like, who knows, a whole new world for you.
Yeah,
have you done any stuff?
I've never drummed. I wish I had, man.
That's
a movie story, but
is that, and that's why you don't tell your mum and dad don't know you on the radio, do they?
I think when they were down the other weekend, they had to come in here. I just said, oh, I'll just go in and press the buttons.
Because they could listen on Sky Digital, couldn't they?
They could do.
But you wouldn't want that, would you?
I don't want that.
No. Play a record, I want to talk to you again a little bit about this later.
Yeah.
Right.
Okay, honey,
this is all about, like, your presents.
What did you want when you were a kid? What's your best present you ever had?
There's a few things. I mean, one that I always remember, one Christmas, right? It was the year when computers first came out.
Right.
And there was one called the Sinclair Spectrum that I wanted, right?
What year are we talking, 84?
Must be 83, 84,
right,
yeah. And, anyway, I think my mum and dad's got me one. It's under the tree in a big box. I'm thinking, yeah, that's about right.
Yeah.
About the size of a computer. Brilliant. Anyway, Christmas Day comes, I couldn't sleep and all that, excited like you are as a kid.
Yeah.
Get up, open it. It's not the one I wanted. Right?
Really?
It's not the Spectrum. It was a ZX81.
Okay.
Right? So I thought, well, I'd best not show that I'm disappointed in that. You know, even as a kid, you have sort of, you know, that thing of
You've lost that. Now you say, oh, it's not what I wanted, Suzanne, but go on.
Yeah, but you know, so I sort of, you know, pretended I liked it and that. I thought, oh, just play some games on it. I'll just get on with it, right? Anyway, I try and load.
Sure. Even as a kid, he had the way of the world. I know.
His parents have saved up for it.
Look at his frown lines. Look, he's frowned since he was about four.
Yeah.
Look at those lines.
Right. So, yeah, but this is why. You'll understand in a minute when I tell you the end of this story.
Go on.
So, I load up a computer game, which used to take about 10 minutes.
Right? Was it on cassette?
Yeah, it sounds like a fax machine, doesn't it? Yeah.
Right? Anyway, it wouldn't load. I was thinking, what's up with this? Is it broke? Right? And I kept trying it, and my dad sort of... my mum used to get up early to open the presents with me. My dad got up at about midday, he couldn't be bothered. Right? Anyway, he comes
this
down and
so stuff. This is so telling. I know, the picture he paints is so heartbreaking.
Like Alan Bennett or something. Yeah. Or Dickens.
Yeah, right. Or someone of those kind of 60s back, like Kathy Come Home, sort of, you know, really in sync dramas.
So anyway, so I'm there, right, getting frown growing and that.
Yeah.
Trying try to read this book, thinking, why isn't it working? So my dad has a look, and he goes, oh, you're missing a bit. I said, what? He goes, you need a RAM pack, right, which is a bit that you put in the back of it that gives it extra memory.
Yeah.
So I'm like, what do you
need? You need one of them.
I'm like, what do you mean? It's Christmas Day, right? And we're talking about the days when, like, Tandy wasn't open. It wasn't open for days.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? It's like now, by lunchtime, Christmas Day, everything's open again.
Yeah,
right?
Sure, yeah.
Then you had to wait about 2 weeks. Everyone like had a big holiday and everything.
Yeah.
So I'm like, oh, God. Oh, I actually started to be sick, right, with frustration.
Oh, no!
What?
With how old were you?
Do you know what?
How old were you?
Well, like I say, I don't know. It must have been about 8 or something.
Oh.
But that thing of like, what, it's Christmas Day and I can't play with it. And I had to wait for like 2 weeks, what have you. Sat over the kitchen sink, sort of going, stressing out. Hated it. It was a rubbish Christmas.
Wow.
I love the idea of you going,
stress, isn't it?
What did your dad say?
He just sort of said, look, calm down. We'll get you one when the shop's open. And it's like, yeah, but it's 2 weeks, isn't it?
I have never heard anyone being sick from stress.
You're talking about buying presents and stuff. I think I did treat my mum to that. I didn't buy my dad anything. I think that was like when I got a bit older, I used to get my dad something because he wasn't that bothered anyway.
No.
Mm. So, got my mum. There was a cheap shop, right?
Of course. Thank God for that.
Called Snips. Right? So I went in there and I thought, let's see what I can get her. And remember Victoria Plum?
I don't think so.
Well, it's like a fairy character.
Right.
Right. I mean, mum's into gnomes and stuff, right? So I thought, right.
She must be pleased with you then.
Ah, Victoria Plum. I was thinking, is that one of the neighbours? Is it like a brandy liqueur?
Do you remember Victoria Plum?
Victoria Plum.
Victoria Plum, yeah, it's like a little fictional sort of character, right?
Okay.
So I saw it, I thought, yeah, she'll love that, right? So I did my paper round, saved up for 2 weeks, right?
Oh.
Got that sorted, went to Snips, bought the Victoria Plum. Next day, I'm in town with her, right? So I think, I know what I'll do. I said, come in here a minute, right? So we go in and we're looking around and I tested her, right? I went, look at that there. That's all right, isn't it? And she goes, oh, it's bloody awful.
Oh, Carl. Oh, God.
So then Christmas Day comes. I said, don't bother opening it. She said, no, why? I said,
Why did you still give it to her?
So, well, it's too late. I'd already bought it.
Oh, Carl.
So she opened it. And I was like, and she said, oh, well, that's nice. I said, why are you saying that? I said, the other day, so it's bloody awful. She said, oh, no, I thought you were pointing at something else.
Oh, no.
So that's why I don't get anyone anything anymore.
Oh, God. Play record. Good idea, Carl. Just beg. Just ask for other things. What do you want? What do you want for Christmas? You must have a big fan base out there willing to make you things. Maybe like a little, I don't know, gloves, pair of gloves.
A little woolly hat. Do you want to send a necklace in for Suzanne? That'd be handy.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
That's what she wants.
Is Suzanne listening today?
No, she's out.
Right, okay, this is the dilemma. Me and Steve, yesterday, were trying to convince Carl that it would be a good idea to buy Suzanne a Christmas present.
Mm.
Okay. Now, why aren't you going to buy a Christmas present? Explain, Carl, why you don't think you should buy a Christmas present.
No, I've told her I'll get her one, but in the new year. We're going away on holiday and that, so there's no point taking stuff away.
Yeah.
Going to Lanzarote next week.
Just get something in the sales after Christmas,
Yeah.
Right. And me and Steve were trying to explain to Carl that she would love it if you bought her something on Christmas Day.
Yeah, but she knows now.
Knows what?
I've told her. So
no,
she's
well, I'm going to tell you. Know, right, this, dear listener, this was Carl's worry. I said, I bet she's got you something, and Carl was worried in case he got her something and she hadn't got him something.
Yeah, he'd be livid.
He didn't want to be down. He didn't want to be a present down.
Yeah.
Look at his face! So buy a nice necklace. Don't spend, just spend 100 quid, you know, just a little token.
We're going away. We're not taking her away on holiday.
No, you're not taking her away on holiday. What, you're paying for it, are you?
Yeah.
Are you really?
Well, half and half and that.
Right.
So you're paying for you to go on holiday? That's good of you. So the gift is your company, really?
She's done alright.
She's done alright!
Why do you talk like you're 60 years old? And you've been working down the mines?
I love that she's done alright. Do you go over to her and say, Suzanne, you're bloody lucky.
I mean,
you've fallen on your feet. Look who you've got. What?
I'm not sure she has done alright. I don't want to be critical, but.
Oh dear.
So what are you going to get in the sales?
What are you going to get her?
Oh, it depends. I'm thinking, I mean, I'll give her the choice. She can have Kingsley and all Bob Marley. Right, I'll let her decide there.
Oh yeah. Dear.
I
can't wait to see you. Where are you going, Lanzarote?
Yeah.
Where's that?
I don't know, Suzanne sorted it.
I said, Lanzarote, is that Africa or is it Spain or Portugal? Just thought you were, dunno, I went, what do you mean, dunno? Well, what's the currency? Went, dunno. I said, Suzanne booked this one, did she?
Yeah.
I thought, where is it? Is Lanzarote African or?
Foreign. Somewhere foreign.
I was looking last night, and, doesn't look that good. like, one of the highlights of the things it says you've got to do is go and have, apparently they've got restaurants in caves, and that's, like, one of the things they say you must do.
Mm.
So, if that's a highlight, do you know what I mean?
Right.
So we'll do that. Go and see what that's like.
Yeah.
When you're on the beach, Carl, do you wear the very, very tight Speedos?
No.
Do you walk around with
them? Sort of longish shorts,
yeah.
T-shirt on, probably with a sort of a light shirt on top of that.
Right, sure.
So quite wrapped up then?
Covered up. Do you wear a hat? Because obviously the bald head, there's risk of sunburn.
No, just put a bit of lotion on it.
Lotion on there.
Yeah. Yeah.
Just have a bit of a wander. Wander down the beach, have a look.
Yeah.
See if there's any old blokes with their tackle out and a backpack.
I want to look forward to, so.
Yeah.
There you go.
Yeah. Well, we're looking forward to finding out how you get on.
Yeah.
Like, and interested to know what she gives you on Christmas Day.
More scintillating chat after this next song.
Right. Bit of Placebo.
Yeah, love it. I'm just actually quite affected by Carl's Victoria Plum scenario. Just the fact that, like, that eagerness, he wants to make sure it's a great present. He's saved up his paper round. He thinks it's like a gnome, but modern.
I'm worried that you're using it as an excuse now, and that's why you're not buying anyone any gifts, because you've had your fingers burned once. I mean, you were 6, 7 years old, to be fair.
No, you weren't. You're about 13, weren't you, because you're on your paper round?
Yeah, it must have been 11 or 12 then.
All right.
Yeah, so I'd saved up. Oh, no, I'm not using it as a thing, it's just that...
What do you get your mum this year?
I've sent them some money so they can, get a passport.
Are they trapped somewhere? they're in a holding bay somewhere in Dover.
Yeah, like, friend who's a truck driver is going to sneak them across.
What do you mean?
So they can buy a passport. What do they do, sell it when they're a bit down in their luck?
No, they haven't got that much money, right? They've never been abroad, and the mate said they might take them next year, and they said, oh, we haven't got a passport, so
I thought... You've got to buy a passport, have you? Isn't that your God-given right as an Englishman?
No, you've got to pay for them. They're 30 quid each, so you better add to, otherwise they're conning me.
Right.
You don't get born with a passport, of course
you sent them 60 quid in an envelope, have you?
Well, check.
Right.
Yeah. I love that. If you're watching telly, France will come on, and they go, oh, what do you think of that? She goes, it looks bloody awful. Yeah, don't open it. Yeah. Don't open it.
So you've not paid for a holiday for them? No, I've just sorted out the...
Well, it's the better prize, isn't it? Because they can't go anywhere without it.
Well, the passport keeps on giving.
Yeah.
So 10 years. 10 years. That is.
So, but no, I never used to, I mean, I can't think of other things. I used to get my dad once I started getting him stuff, it used to be a dressing gown.
Yeah.
And then... But as an extra surprise, he used to put, like, a cigar in the pocket, so he'd think that was it.
Yeah.
Then he'd put it on and put his hand in the pocket.
Right. And then he'd just hit you because he thought you'd nicked it.
Yeah. Oh, dear.
So you bought him a jacket with a cigar? That's quite thoughtful.
Yeah. Didn't you sneak a cigar once on Christmas?
Yeah, well, that's when they used to have, like, the big do's, like I say. You know, they were known for it. Like, the whole estate used to know that you know, we were having a party.
Yeah. So, to them. So they'd all come round.
So they all come round and scat food and drink and that.
God,
and
pocket the, yeah, I can't ovens. Imagine. I cannot imagine how unpleasant that must have been.
Awful.
And you locked in your bedroom with a broken train set.
Yeah. Quite.
And looking at Victoria Plum, whatever that was.
In the bin.
Oh, in the bin, yeah. And hear a mum saying, and he got me this.
He got me this, isn't this piece shit? Of rubbish.
You could hear him just throwing it against the wall and laughing.
All, and all the neighbours laughing. Yeah. Yeah.
And you'd come down just being pieces with loads of spit on it. Yeah. Just loads of gob on it. Ice. And all the Polaroids of them just like laughing at it and pointing, stamping on it.
Yeah.
All right.
Well, just brought all the flooding back.
But no, I used to get up in the morning and then like they'd still sort of all be there asleep on the floor and on the sofa. And
that's awful. That's terrible. Christmas is surely the one day a year which is a family thing. It's for the kids. They're the ones.
No, that was Boxing Day.
Well, I know.
That's all right. It's not as it's over.
Yeah.
Back on Christmas the bike. All right. Who's going to pay for this? What, me? Yes, Carl. You're doing two rounds today.
Yeah, what's your paper round supporting the entire family?
Yeah.
No, so I used to get up and, like, go downstairs, and they'd be asleep, so I'd be mooching about trying to find, like, another present that's still working.
So, I love the idea that these people from the estate had, like, squashed his presents.
So I found a cigar that had been sort of lit up and then put out, so I thought, oh, I'll have a go at that. Yeah. I went outside and had a go, and that's the last time I smoked.
Right.
Sort of, I tried it, I thought, I don't like that.
I love the fact that he does everything once.
Yeah.
In his life. It's like it's a line of, I've done everything once. I don't need to do it again. Right. Come up to Christmas. Some people forget the true meaning of Christmas. I just think it's drinking and giving presents. But obviously it comes from the story of the nativity. Very briefly, what is the story of Christmas, as you remember?
It's baby Jesus was born. So,
Okay. Let's can we expand on that a little? Let's start the night before. What happened on Christmas Eve?
She was Mary was pregnant.
Right.
She's wandering about. You know, probably knowing it was due. Was she knocking about with the three fellas at that point?
No. No. Three fellas being...
The wise men.
No.
She wasn't with them.
No. Who was she with?
I honestly don't know.
What was her husband called?
Her husband was... I don't know. I wasn't that interested in Ari. Jesus was born...
Right, okay, Mary and Joseph, yeah?
Yeah, yeah.
They travelled, didn't they? On a donkey.
Yeah.
What happened?
She's pregnant.
Yeah, we've done that.
And then she's like, I'm going to have this kid in a bit, sort somewhere out.
Right.
He says, we're going to struggle.
She came from Salford.
It's Christmas Eve.
Right.
And they stayed at her.
No, it wasn't Christmas Eve, was it?
All right, then it's just a normal day, and they stayed. They couldn't find it. They couldn't find anywhere,
right?
So they stayed in a stable,
right?
She had the kid on December 25th. That's it.
Then what happened?
That's it, really?
No, it was the three fellas she was knocking about with at the beginning.
The wise men,
right?
And there was a star involved. They followed a star. You see, you're making me look like a divvy, but it wasn't an important lesson at school. I'm not a Catholic or anything. I'm nothing. I'm sort of... My mum even said, she said, don't tell anyone that you're not anything. She said, because something about witches. When I was a kid, when you're a kid, you're at risk of being taken away.
People think he's a character. People think this is scripted. No, imagine if I bothered writing this.
But it's not important. It's so not important, this story.
What did your mum say about witches?
No, she just said, don't go around telling people you're not christened or anything.
Right.
I did a Sunday school thing called Crusaders.
Right.
Joined that. But I just went on like the Friday when they had Sabutio, table football. And then they came knocking on the Sunday saying, come on, you've got to come with us.
Right.
And I went and it was rubbish. There was no Sabutio. There's an old fella reading out a smelly Bible, really old books. And I hated it. I said, I'm not going on a Sunday again. So I used to just go on the Friday, and that is religion for me.
There you go.
I didn't need it. I don't need an old story.
Final thoughts. What does Christmas mean to you then, Carl? If you don't like old stories, what does Christmas mean to you? Just look down and tell people what they should be thinking of this Christmas. What does it mean to you?
It's hassle, isn't it, Christmas? Got to buy presents. The meal's all right. The food's all right.
It's the best, isn't it? If the roast dinner is the, you know, the king of meals, surely the Christmas roast is the king of roasts.
Yeah. Christmas. I could do without it. If someone said, we're getting rid of it, I'd go, all right. I don't like all the build-up. I don't like that bit in between Christmas and New Year when nothing's happening. That's a dead week. Nothing goes on. People are still off for Christmas. Christmas has happened. Get back to work. You can get nothing done. Everything comes to a standstill. Why do you like Christmas?
I like being allowed to drink gin and tonic at 10 a.m. while watching Noel Edmonds give little sick kids presents.
Well, that's what I mean. That's what it's about. It's not about, you're saying to me, telling me the story of baby Jesus. You haven't got a clue yourself. It's not about that. It's about, like you say, eating chocolates. Same as Easter is for fat people with chocolate. I love Easter. No, you don't. You like eggs. You like chocolate, you fat little... Do you know what I mean? So, we don't need it. Maybe back then, when you were, you know, wise men knocking about a desert, they needed something to look forward to. They probably didn't live that long.
I don't think they were looking forward to Easter, though, were they?
No, but listen... But
Jesus certainly wasn't looking forward to Easter.
Back then, when you watched Scrooge, Everyone's looking forward to it. Tiny Tim, go and get a chicken. Now, these days, have a chicken when you want. Anyone can afford it. So it hasn't got the same values.
Tiny Tim, go and get a chicken. Oh.
Happy Christmas.
Brilliant. I want to see a Victoria Plum. I want to know what it is. Does it look like a little gnome?
It's a woman gnome.
A female gnome?
Yeah.
A little gnome. Did your mum collect gnomes?
She likes anything gnomes, she likes fairies, she likes Indians. She collects all that stuff. Yeah, and it doesn't matter what it is.
What do you mean?
You know, like a proper Indian with all the ad gear on.
Or a Native American.
She likes anything with M on, like, you know, it can be a fridge magnet. It can be just anything.
A lot of Native American wisdom is around the fridge magnet because they think it has special powers of adhesion. You read some of their writings, the great works.
I just have to show you something, Rick, before we move on. I know we've got another Educating Ricky, but someone just sent this in. Yeah. They've been looking on eBay for Victoria Plum.
You're joking.
Come here and see the photograph.
Oh, God, that's fantastic.
That's it.
Oh, God, he's got that for his mum!
It's the worst piece of tat I've ever seen.
Oh, Carl! Imagine how...
Gutted.
Carl. Imagine how... Look, think of him now, right? There it is! That's the worst thing I've ever seen! I tell you what, it looks like a Diddy man gone wrong.
It
looks like a Diddy man prostitute. That is...
is that the one, Carl?
It was a different colour. It had a yellow at.
How do they get? Tell them they're going to eBay.
So you need to log on to ebay.co.uk. I'm sure you've used it before. It's the online marketplace, ebay.co.uk. And if you type in Victoria Plum, I'm assuming that you can track this down.
That's amazing.
It's the worst piece of rubbish I've ever
seen. Just think how cute he was as a kid, though, doing that. Just think of him just going...
just seeing that
and thinking, she likes gnomes! It's the worst thing I've ever seen!
I mean, to be fair, I don't know what her prize collection of gnomes looks like, but I can't imagine they're much better than that. I mean, gnomes are a fairly grotesque thing. But certainly your mum's taste and discretion is...
Did you ever, those houses on your estate, you'd go in there and it was just loads of those dolls still in their packaging all around the room? And sort of like, one of those homes that keeps the, sort of packaging on the three-piece suite.
Why don't you buy another one for her for Christmas?
Yeah.
It's £3.99, it looks, but that's £2.49. Because that was $3.99.
Well. Oh, buy it, Carl.
No, because I've got her, I've sorted out her passport this year anyway. I'll get her that next year.
Can I just ask Carl how he got on over Christmas? Because the last time I spoke to him, you hadn't bought a present for your girlfriend. I have to say, I was on tenterhooks all Christmas.
Well, you changed it. After that show, I felt bad, even though I shouldn't have done, because...
because you hadn't bought your girlfriend a Christmas present.
Yeah, but I said to you, I booked a table at a hotel in Covent Garden, had Christmas dinner there, which was nice, right? Mm. It's good food and everything.
It didn't feel like enough to me.
Well, then I went out and treated some stuff, and then...
No. A couple of days before Christmas, he went, I took Suzanne to that hotel we're going to go to for Christmas dinner. We had tea and cakes. And I went, oh, you treated her? He went, no, she paid for it. But I was just showing her what it was going to be like. That was her extra treat. She paid for it. I love that.
Brilliant.
Yeah. Well, it was a deal. It was like 150 quid for a meal for two, which is pretty dear. So I'm not going to buy her cakes as well.
I love that. All right, love, have anything you want. You pay for your own pudding. I'm not mental.
So you treated her to some other stuff?
Yeah, some bits and bobs.
What,
and
so yesterday... she chose them and you paid for them?
What, the presents?
Yeah.
No, or you chose them and she paid for them, but, you know, it's not the counts.
I got them on the way home that Saturday.
Well done.
And what did you buy?
Well, just some bits.
Might be personal, Steve.
Well, I don't care.
Just some bits.
Yeah,
just
bits and pieces. Leave out the personal bits. What bits?
Just little things. And then yesterday, right?
A monkey wrench and a new washer for the shower.
Yeah. Some recordable CDs. That you need for your job.
Now,
when you gave those presents to her, did her face light up?
Right. I don't want to tell you what they were, right, but she wasn't that impressed.
You're going to tell us what they are now,
tell us what they are.
You even know what they are, she told you, on Christmas Day.
Hold on, wait a minute.
But right. It doesn't matter what they are.
It does matter what they are.
It doesn't matter.
Carl, it's you, mate. Of course it doesn't matter.
Oh, God!
We just remember.
Yeah!
Right, but don't... There's no need.
I've got to tell him, Carl. I really want your permission, because I don't want to be a... You know, I know it's not... But we know it's not that embarrassing. It's really quite sweet.
Yeah, but in a way, right, the way I look at it is, right, Christmas... Even when I was a little kid, right? It's not.
Please let me tell him, Carl.
Well, let me just tell you first, though. Oh. Let me tell you why I didn't go all out on the old present front.
All right. Justify yourself.
Right?
Oh,
first
God.
Of all, I've covered it up since then anyway, right? With that present, because I bought her some shoes yesterday. And she did say, I'll give you the money for them, but when I get home, I said, it's all right. I said, you can have them. Right? So not only did I buy her some food on Christmas Day, I got shoes. She's probably had a
tattoo. And they treat you like a horse.
Yeah.
It's not like, yeah, there you go. There's your shoes. There's your food. Right. Bed down. See you later.
Yeah, but what I'm saying is she's done.
Fed and clothed.
Yeah. Did you comb her hair?
She's done well this year, right? So, the thing
she's
is.
She's done well this year. It's like you're a single parent living on a council estate with a smack problem. And you still managed to buy some Lego.
When I was a kid, it wasn't about what you got. I remember one year when I was about 8, right?
Oh, this is going to make me cry, isn't it, this?
No, it's not. I'm just saying the way it is, right? I woke up at about 4 in the morning, and I was like, oh, what have I got? And I couldn't sleep. I was that on edge. Mm. It's the excitement of Christmas, isn't it? It's like, oh, what's wrapped up? I need to know.
Sure. Yeah.
And it's the fact that people are saying, no, you won't know until tomorrow.
Yes.
Sure. That annoys you and winds you up.
Okay.
So I got up at 4 in the morning,
yeah.
Opened my presents, and then went, right, I know now, went back to bed, had a great sleep.
Yes.
Right? So it's nothing to do with the excitement of what you get, it's the excitement of not knowing what you've got.
And then what happened when you got up to go down with the presents?
What you're saying to me is that you could wrap up a brick because the thrill of Christmas is in hoping and being excited about what it is, not the actual gift itself.
Yeah.
Is that what you did, Rick? did she get a brick?
No, let me tell him now what he got. He got her a present, right, and she said, she came and I said, yeah, he got me. It was an industrial-sized packet of condoms.
It was a joke gift.
No, it wasn't a joke gift.
It wasn't even a joke.
I went home that Saturday after the year, past Boots, thought, might have something in here. They were on, like, some value.
Right, you passed the makeup.
Used?
You passed all the other...
Yeah. Passed the makeup, stuff. Passed the lovely vanity cases,
yeah,
yeah, the foot spas,
exactly.
Yeah, yeah, oh, hold on. How much are these, love, for 100?
Yeah.
$4.99. Yeah.
Do I get them reduced if I buy in bulk?
So how many did you buy, what was it?
I don't know, probably about 100.
Right, okay.
And is she allowed to use those with anyone?
Did you wrap them?
Could she just go out and have a walk?
Well, you don't need to wrap, they're already wrapped, aren't they?
Oh.
And then what did she say when she opened them? Carl, what did she say?
Right, play a record and we'll come back to this.
Put your
wrote words to my father. That's genius.
Steve, who got on right?
You're such an idiot.
I don't know what to say to this guy. I mean, as soon as Christmas is over, pop in somewhere, get yourself checked out. Steve, I don't know how you pronounce his surname, Steve Toes or Steve Toze. He says, admittedly, this is the worst quiz ever.
It is the worst quiz ever.
He's still got the answers.
Nice one.
And he also says, say hello to my Mrs. Amy, who's up the duff for Christmas. Lovely, a wonderful poetic image.
That's lovely, isn't it?
Yeah. Appropriate as well, you know, baby Jesus born this year, you know, born this year in something or other.
Don't be going into that.
Why?
Well, it's, you know, BBC and everything, you've got a, you know, there's a lot of people out there, different religions and that, let's not talk about little baby Jesus and that.
Why not?
But you can talk
just
about
best,
Jesus.
Just leave it.
Well, have you just been saying Christmas all the time? What are you talking about? What have you been reading?
I'm just saying.
This is like last year when I was at the Christmas dinner table with my parents, and my sister is religious, I'm not, and we were arguing about Jesus, the meaning of Jesus, and my mum said, "Will you stop arguing about Jesus? It's not the time." I was thinking, well, this has got to be the time. Yeah. I mean, there's no other time than his birthday.
No, I agree with you.
One and two. I think the time to talk about Jesus is Christmas and Easter.
Easter.
That's pretty much the big two.
It's popular at this time of the year, but I'm just saying it's best. You know, there's other people out there. Do you know what I mean? We're going out to.
But we're talking to everyone. It's just we just happen to be here at the Festival of Christmas.
Right, yeah. Well, happy Christmas to everyone.
Play a record.
Just take us through the moment where you gave this gift.
So you went into Boots, right? You thought, all right, 100 condoms, brilliant. Mm. Okay, did you wrap it up?
I don't know if it was 100, probably 80.
Right, okay, yeah. Right. You don't want to go mad, do you?
Wrap them up.
I'm just resting easy knowing that he's not trying to breed.
Right. No.
Yeah.
So, I got her them. I got her Grease on DVD because she's always watching that.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. So I just think of when her mum said, "What did Carl get you? Some condoms and Grease."
Yeah, I was just saying, I'm glad he said on DVD.
Yeah. Right. She was surprised anyway, right? Because
I bet she was.
No, when she got
she was thinking like jewellery.
No.
So right. That showed her. That surprised you, hasn't it? Alright?
So hang on, wait a minute.
You thought it was a holiday, didn't you? Yeah, look at your face!
You don't know me at all. So hang on, so did you give these on Christmas Day?
Right, what happened is, she got in from work that Saturday, right? And I said, look under the tree.
Knackered, oh, right. At least it's Christmas. Yeah. At least I'm gonna get a little bit.
I said, look, you got some stuff under the tree, right? So,
did you give her a sugar lump?
Right, she was really chuffed with that. But she said she was a bit puzzled because I didn't know we had any wrapping paper, right? So I ended up using wallpaper.
You didn't take it off the wall, though. You had
No, it was some left over, right? So she said, "Why have you used wallpaper?" I said, "Well, I didn't have any paper, and you were getting in a bit, and I wanted you to have a surprise." So she said, "Can I have a feel of them?"
I said, "The presents."
She thought, "Right, I've got the right thing."
Yeah,
right.
And then Christmas Day. I said, no, don't get carried away, it's nothing really good, you know, we said we weren't going to buy each other much. So there you go, open them.
Yeah, go on.
And,
can I just ask, had you received your present from her yet?
Yeah.
So what had you received?
What did they have? Had some shoes.
Nice.
Right. Getaway game for PlayStation.
Nice.
I'm just tightening up just the value of those. Yeah. Go on, yeah.
And just also think about how much fun and pleasure you get from them.
Although, of course,
condoms, I can see the...
Well,
see the appeal.
Also
add to that bit 150 quid for a meal. If you're going to start totting up, 150 quid for a meal. I bought some shoes 72 quid.
Yeah, that was after the event, though.
Doesn't matter.
All right, so you've received these, dare I say it, thoughtful and nice gifts. You handed over the box of condoms. They were wrapped up. She unwrapped them.
Yeah.
Go on, take us through it. Walk us through it.
Well. It's not something you play with on Christmas morning.
Oh God! Oh,
But when she opened
what did she say?
I wrapped them twice as well, so she thought it was something really good.
Extra protection,
right?
And
so she thought it was something really good,
and then
the disappointment would be doubled.
Yeah, go on, yeah.
Then she just opened it and went, "Oh yeah, so what's on the telly?" And that
God,
was that.
Ungrateful!
What, was that?
What an ungrateful woman that is.
Well,
fancy,
she got stuff.
Fancy not wanting.
I told her
a box of economy condoms from Boots.
I said to her about the thing about, you know, it's all about the surprise and that, isn't it?
Yeah,
you explained that to her.
Yeah.
What, after she'd unwrapped it?
Yeah. Thoughtful. And she was all right about it.
Yeah. She understood.
Rick, you know I suggested to him that he buy his girlfriend a gift. I'm worried I've done more damage to the relationship by suggesting that than if he had just forgotten.
Next time you've got to go shopping for yourself, Steve.
I think I might do.
You've better go shopping for yourself.
I'm glad it's all over, though. It's mental.
Yeah.
It annoys me. The whole thing annoys me. And she knows that as well.
Yeah.
She should know. What, she still insists on having Christmas once a year?
Well.
I'm you know.
No, but, well, anyway, what did you get?
I can't think what you bring to the relationship, Carl. I don't know what it is she's getting from you in this relationship. It's like she's doing all the work.
Well, yeah. 80 times. Oh, God, Carl. I love it. You're brilliant. I know what she's getting. He's the...
What, though? He's not thoughtful.
No, but he's thoughtful. He's the best he can do with the brain he's got. Do you know what I mean?
Right.
He's doing his best. Mm. He's absolutely doing his best. There's no...
He's working at the limits of his powers.
Do you know what I mean, though? He's done as well as he can with what he was given.
Sure.
Yeah, I mean, and that's admirable.
Yeah.
It's like, I think he's done better than you'd expect. I bet his teachers didn't even think he'd get this far. Do you know what I mean?
What, find a girl?
No, well, yeah, a job, a girl.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? Clothed himself. He's done really well. What do you think, Carl? You think you've done well?
I think I've done all right compared to some of my mates.
What are they doing now?
Probably not that much. Mm. Do you know what I mean? The Mrs. Matthews said I wouldn't be an high flyer. I think I'm doing all right.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? They have a holiday every year. Got somewhere to live and that.
Yeah. Got a new flat, haven't you?
Yeah, so...
So where are they then, the condoms? Did she show them to her family and friends?
No.
Take them into work? Look what Carl got.
I'm surprised she told Ricky, actually. I was a bit disappointed in that.
Yeah.
Because I didn't go shouting around.
Well, she was so excited, Carl, clearly. She's just so pleased and proud.
All right. Play record, we come back to it.
And then we've got a Christmas edition of Rockbusters,
which
I found out yesterday.
Go on.
Channel 4 have ripped it off.
Go on.
It's on their teletext thing.
That's outrageous.
Yeah, on their teletext page, someone said.
What are they doing then?
Like Rockbusters, they're copying the format.
You sure they're not copying Blockbusters?
No, it's someone said it's a cryptic clue of a band and that, and initials, and you work it out.
That is despicable. I mean, right. We should investigate this.
So they've fundamentally ripped off the idea of being allowed to do a cryptic clue to guess a band.
Yeah, but they sort of clever cryptic clues.
They ripped you off then, haven't they?
I'm just saying.
Hey, so. I should just point out, because it's Christmas time, we've had an email from Dickie Anderson.
Oh, Dickers.
RA is, he's I suppose he's a long time listener.
Yeah.
And he emails us most weeks. Ricky. If, as I suspect, I'm your only listener, I wouldn't bother with your show today, as I've got to attend some family Christmas nonsense at Auntie Marion's house. That's from Dickie Anderson, and he's good because considering he hates the show and everything we stand for, he does take the time to email every week.
That counts to advertisers.
Yeah.
I think we've got a lot like him. We've also had a lovely Christmas card here from Alexandra, right? Who's wishes she loves the show. She loves you, Carl. And she's enclosed some biscuits for you to save you a bit of money because she knows you goes out and get your own biscuits. Then we've got some lovely little packet of Fox's
Creations.
Well,
why don't you wrap them up and you can give them to your girlfriend? So what did you do for New Year, incidentally?
Well, I cocked it up a bit.
You're joking, mate. Go on.
I went and booked a table.
You got the wrong day.
No, right. booked a table at a restaurant that was shut. Right?
What?
I booked a table at a restaurant, and the one that I called, it wasn't the one. The call had been diverted. So Suzanne said, call them up and see what they're serving. Right? Because I forgot to do that when I booked the table, right?
That's great, anyway. So
because the thing is, right, it's a restaurant in Covent Garden, but they've got one in Victoria. But when they answered and they said, no, Victoria, I thought that was the person who was answering the phone. Do you know how some people say the name?
Right.
Right? So then when I called them up and said, what you saying?
You thought he sounded a bit funny.
Right? So,
I'm confused, Carl, but probably not more. It was a branch of a...
He doesn't want to give the restaurant away. So he phoned it up, there's one in Covent Garden, they answered the phone.
So the restaurant's not called no.
No, they said no, Victoria.
Why can't we name the restaurant?
I don't know why. It's not libelous.
Are we scared that, like, are you scared people are going to sort of see you in there because it's your regular haunt?
No, it's just that, you know, you got to pay for stuff, haven't you?
Right.
I mean, it's...
Okay, anyway, so you've got...
I mentioned it before New Year, but it's not...
So did you go all the way to the restaurant to find out that it was closed?
No. What happened is I called...
Was that the name of the restaurant again?
Right, the restaurant's called Christopher's. They've got one in Covent Garden, they've got one in Victoria. He phoned up, he went to book, it's a lovely restaurant, I've been there often, I recommend it to him. He phones up, says, can I have a table for new, he said, no problem, sir. Right? And then, so Dan said, oh, you better call up, see if they've got any haddock on the, menu. And he went, hello, and they went, hello, Christopher's. Victoria went, Victoria? They went, yeah, he went, oh, no. That's it, innit?
So then I just said, no, forget it. I'm not going all the way over there. So I cancelled it, right? So then I called up Suzanne and said, look, I made an error. The place we were going to is shut.
Was she surprised again, or?
So we're not going. So she said, oh, try some other places. And I did. They were all booked up, right? I was fed up anyway. I hate New Year. It's always like this, isn't it? So I said, look.
You know the common factor in all these stories? You hate Christmas, you hate Christmas, it's you hate New Year. It is you.
Right. Yeah.
So I said, I'll sort something out. Yeah. So I went to Tesco.
Leave it with me. Went to Tesco's, booth was shut. Tesco. Got a lovely plate of condoms.
Did you just stay in and play with her birthday?
Blowing them up. I've done some balloons.
Well, it was. I think we did stay in. And I watched that thing that, you know, 100 Greatest Moments, which was annoying me. Did you see, there was a nudist on it. You know how I feel about them.
Mm, yeah.
Right? Did you see him?
Man with two knobs.
There was a man with two knobs on it. And a nudist who just like wanders about the house.
But it said, and when he visits people, I was thinking, who lets him visit? I go,
exactly. Yeah.
But he must go there with trousers on and go, hello, lovely to see you. Can I just pop all these off? Well, not really, no.
And I tell you what annoyed me the most. He had a white sofa. If you were a nudist, you'd get a darker one. Right? So anyway, right. So we ended up watching that. That annoyed me. And then I was tired by about 11 and I said, oh, let's go to bed. And she said, you can't. And that annoys me, the fact that because it's New Year, you got to stay up. And it's like, well, why? Can't we just, you should bring it forward. So in case you want
to quarter to ten.
Well, you stay up and it's like my eyes were dead heavy. And I was like, oh, I want to go to sleep. So just stay up. And then it's midnight and you go Happy New Year. Then you go to bed.
Yeah.
Well, not everyone, Carl. Some people have a little party.
So
it's over with anyway.
Are you 86 years old?
86
Do you ever enjoy? You never seem to have any fun, Carl. This is what disappoints. This is what worries me. I feel like you're going to die.
You're here, you're here, Carl. With us two, we've got three. As I was just saying to Steve, three of the greatest comedy minds ever in one room, and Steve pointed out since the Goodies.
True.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. Well, I mean, this should be Party Central.
Yeah. Yeah, good.
Rockbusters.
Well, tell the prizes, Steve.
Yeah,
tell
we have
Christmas gifts. This is Christmas gifts.
I don't know if you'll receive them in time to actually pass them off as gifts.
I wonder if I can tell that, Ross Noble story that he told us.
I don't know. We'll have to discuss that when the record's playing.
Okay. All right.
Okay, so you heard a track from it just then. It's the XFM Christmas album. I think that's been knocking around here in the office for years, hasn't it, Carl? Or is it new this year?
It was brought out about 2 years ago, okay. Christmas songs are Christmas songs.
Yeah, it's not bad. It's got bands on there like the Dandy Warhols, the Webb Brothers are on there, Drugstore, Bell and Sebastian, Flaming Lips, all sorts. So we've got that to give away. We've also got this Smashing Pumpkins compilation, which we've seen, again, that seems to be knocking around for weeks. Another one of those 50 years of the greatest hit single. I don't know, Culture Club's on there, Queen, obviously.
I've just seen the cult film.
Yeah, the cult film will come back to you shortly. This, I think, is one of the most exciting gifts. If you have a video player and you want to get trim, then surely Big Brother 3 champion Kate Lawler and her cardio combat video, in which I think she uses kind of, I don't know, military boxing training to get you trim and taut and looking as good as her. Then you can get that as well. We've also got a exclusive 7-inch single from the White Stripes, a kind of Christmas single. Is that from them?
Yeah.
That must be quite rare. That's probably the only thing.
That is worth something.
And the current Badly Drawn Boy album, Have You Fed the Fish, which I think is slightly mediocre.
That they've gone up, actually. I think that the level of prizes there has gone up.
Not a bad selection, but here is the big movie. And actually, I have to say, this is not a bad one.
It's not terrible at all.
It could be worse. It's James Caan in the original Rollerball, not the disastrous remake that came out recently, but the DVD version of Rollerball. So that's there as well. So something fairly interesting.
That's worth winning. Yeah. Right, come on then. Selection. Let's do Rockbuster.
Well, will we play a song to give people time to get a pen and paper and that?
Yeah.
Yeah. So we're doing it next.
The supermarket recently, just walking past the condoms on the way to the pornography, and I thought, you know, it's worth perhaps, you know, getting a stocking, you know, getting some condoms.
What, to put over your head? You're not still doing that, are you?
No. I I thought it'd be worth getting some condoms in. You know, it's this, this Christmas party season, and you never know when you're going to run out of balloons. And and I was weird because the condoms in the supermarket are contained in a kind of cage, in a plastic cage, so it makes it all the more embarrassing buying them. Because I took them off the thing, and I was trying to open it. So, because I thought that they would, it, you had to open it.
Try it on. Try it on. Exactly. Okay, this, you know, in case it doesn't fit. Exactly. Bring it back.
Yeah.
Bring it back, yeah.
And
do you do alterations? yeah, we do, yes. £5.
And, so I'm trying to open this thing, and this guy who works there, sort of in his middle-aged guy who works there, goes, you have to take that to the, checkout. So you can't open that yourself. And I was just, cause I don't know, I still find it very embarrassing. You know, dealing with any of that sort of, you know, prophylactics and things. The novelty of that is still very embarrassing to me. And so I just left it. I thought, forget it. I'm not gonna take these to the counter. Because you never know. It's like if you get served by a woman, it's still a bit embarrassing. Particularly if that's all you're buying. Because you know, she knows what you're up to. You're going to fill them up with war and throw them at students. And anyway, the reason I mention this is because it reminded me of the conversation we've all enjoyed in the past, Rick, about when Carl bought for his girlfriend for Christmas, was it a
two pack
of
yeah? What was it? Condoms? Wasn't it about buy one get one free?
Yeah,
it was a bumper family pack, wasn't it? Yeah. Not a family, obviously. That'd be weird.
Yeah, a family pack of condoms, one for the kids. Exactly, enjoy yourselves. So that was a couple of years ago, Carl. The famous condom gate. Have you bucked your ideas up since then?
Not really. They were the early days.
Do you mean the early days? You'd been going out with her for about 8 years, hadn't you?
Yeah, yeah. But I just think that as time goes on, you don't sort of buy each other as many presents.
Sorry. That was a bumper year, was it? That was a hell of a. She went. Oh, I remember when you used to buy me stuff like condoms. It's gone downhill since then.
Well, no, she didn't know she was getting them. What I mean is, there's less.
Of course,
prizes.
She didn't.
That's what I mean, though. It was sort of interesting to when I gave them her, and so there you go, open them. She was not expecting that. And as time goes on...
No, she was probably expecting a piece of jewellery or a holiday in Paris.
It's more difficult, is what I mean, to surprise someone, isn't it,
No, no, no. But the surprise thing is meant to always be a good surprise.
Yeah, but don't... If you always get something good, it's like the three wise men. What did they get the second year for little baby Jesus? Do you know what I mean? Once he's had that gold, it's like... I've sort of made it hard work for myself there. I've got to get him something better than that now. So it's best to give him the myrrh.
And next year, get him the gold.
Step it up a bit or whatever.
But don't you understand? Because I don't want to criticise you because you're a lovely man, but having read the diary and read much of this diary, one of the things I notice is the complete lack of romanticism. The number of times Susanna says, book us a lovely meal out, take me out tonight, and you always write like it's a massive chore, like it's a headache for you. Oh no, I've got to spend a romantic night out with my girlfriend.
Because it's the same reason I don't like Christmas and stuff, is the expectations. I prefer it. If I want to take Suzanne out, I prefer to meet her at the bus stop, and she comes back from work and go, you want to go out?
But you don't do that.
No, I do now and again, but it's that thing of, oh, we'll go out tonight, I want to leave it to you. Book a place, it builds it up too much and it can never live up to it. It's like how you know how like people make a big thing out of, you know, having it away for the first time and they go, oh, I'm going to do that tonight. Not the way to do anything. You won't get anything done by planning.
That's a quote! That's an amazing quote! That'll be up there with Newton and Churchill. You don't get anything done by planning.
No, but like
that's amazing.
Like I've said,
but you can't just spring it on someone. You have to at least ask, are you up for it tonight?
Just see how it goes. That's what I'm saying about Christmas. I might not be in the mood for it on December 25th for Christmas, having turkey and everything. That's what I mean about, you know, in the last podcast, stuff coming round every year. Don't plan it. If you fancy a Christmas, have it. If you don't, just carry on. It'd be nice to live in a world like that. They say, you know, it's a world of freedom or something. No, it isn't.
No, they don't, I don't know what that means.
They say,
like, you know, today's world is a free world or something. Someone said something along them lines when it isn't. Everyone's still being told what to do, when to do it. Christmas is a big thing, isn't it, that we all have to go through. And it's stressful. It's
You're
not a happy
such
time.
A miserable sod. You really
no,
are.
No, but Christmas is a big upheaval.
It is a bit, out of all of those special days that go on, Christmas is the one
that's... what are you doing with your time? It's the question we return to again and again. No, we read it. You're visiting your parents. You're hiring a car. You're going down the calf. It's not like you're taking your work away. You're doing some important neuroscience work.
Yeah.
And we've had to take you away from that for 3 days.
Yeah. No, but what
you're not doing anything of any value,
no.
Carl.
But, no. But no. What I might want to do, but I can't because the shops are shut because they want to go off and celebrate Christmas. You know, it's an upheaval. Easter's all right. It comes and goes. Do you want an egg? Not really. Don't have one then. You're not forced an egg. I like Easter. And everyone can afford an egg. There's no one being left out. Whereas Christmas, everyone like goes back to the family and they have a big meal and all that. And there's a lot of poor people out there who can't do that. So it's more of a, if you're going to talk about religion and, you know, the religious sort of occasions, Easter's one that I'd keep. If you plan everything, you probably won't do it in the end. Whereas...
again, that as a soundbite is gobbledygook, isn't it?
No, what I mean is, say like holidays, when you know they're coming, you never enjoy them as much as one when it's surprised on you.
Who surprises someone with a holiday unless you win it on a game show?
How can you go, bloody hell, I'm on holiday?
Suzanne did it with me. She sorted it all out and booked me time off work without me knowing.
Oh, that's a lovely romantic gift.
Oh, yeah, and nice. I went along with it and we had a great little holiday.
Yeah, so maybe you should do something like that for her.
No. She wouldn't like it as much, and I won't pick the right place, and I know she won't like it.
You are one of these people that washes up badly, so you'll never be asked again, aren't
you? No, that's my job. That's the only job I do.
It was a...
but to be honest, that's doing me head in at the moment, because I've outgrown the sink.
He talks about himself like a crab!
Carl Pilkington. The man of the moment with his rockbusters coming your way with all those great prizes.
Yeah. Yeah. Right, are we doing it now?
Yes, sir.
I noticed Heat magazine sort of put a bit of a spanner in the works.
Why?
Because they were saying, oh, maybe it'll be a Christmas edition of Rockbusters. And I'd already sorted them out.
I wouldn't worry, Carl.
Well, what I've done, I've cleverly tweaked them to make them Christmassy. So the Christmas bit in it has got nothing to do with it whatsoever, but I just thought...
So you mean the clues have a Christmas element?
Well,
But it's nothing to do with the answer.
It's nothing to do with the answer, right?
So why don't you just ask the normal ones and I'll ring a bell, I'll shake some bells.
Well, go, it's ho, the equivalent ho, ho. Of that, but in sort of speech, right? Brilliant. So the first one, there's a load of letters there asking for advice. Put them on Claire's desk. Oh, and have a good Christmas.
Oh! give it to us again.
Oh God!
Right, so there's a load of letters asking for advice. Put them on Claire's desk. Oh, and have a good Christmas.
Right, but bear in mind, people, that the Christmas element may not be relevant to these clues.
No, it's got nothing to do with it. I don't want to. Okay. You know, and the initial letter is F. Right, that's F.
All right.
Right, the second one. ask your mum if you should. After you've wrapped the presents. Right, so
ask your mum if you should.
Ask your mum if you should after you've wrapped the presents. That's S.
S.
S. Alright. Alright.
Okay.
And the last one, a couple of people were arguing in the supermarket at the fruit and veg counter. But it's busy in there because it's Christmas. So that's probably what brought it on. So that's B. Right?
Oh.
B.
Oh God!
So they're the three. Will I just recap?
Yes, please.
Yeah, I've no idea. So I can't even. One. I don't know what to start thinking.
Right, there's a load of letters there asking for advice. Put them on Claire's desk.
Have a good Christmas.
Have a good Christmas. Second one, ask your mum if you should.
After you wrote the present.
S. And the last one, a couple of people were arguing in the supermarket at the fruit and veg counter.
But it's busy in there because it's Christmas.
It's busy because it's Christmas. That's a B. So they're the three things.
It's email only, this one. Please remember that. ricky.gervais@xfm.co.uk. ricky.gervais@xfm.co.uk.
Yep. Brilliant. Carl looks happy with them. He looks really happy with them.
So they're cracking.
They're good.
Yeah, all right. Is there going to be more Rockbusters in the new year? We're not sure.
I'm still, thinking about new ideas that we can do.
Okay.
Are we starting Ricky Ridiculous today? Have you done
Couldn't be bothered.
Couldn't be bothered.
Couldn't be hard.
Carl's not really in a festive mood, but,
I can't imagine Christmas is your time of year, is it, Carl? Well, I'm not sure any time of the year is, really.
I liked it when I was about... I think when I was about 7, I enjoyed it.
Mm. Was that the one? Was that the year, the big year for you?
You get loads of stuff, you don't have to worry about anyone else, but once you've, like, got a job...
What did you get when you... When were you doing your paper round? How old were you then?
I was about, 13, 14.
Well, that was your own man, weren't you?
I had to buy stuff.
Oh.
But you're still not
having
a good time.
You're quite selfish, man, aren't you? I didn't realise this.
No, it's just that Christmas...
And that's coming from him, Carl.
My dad always said...
Oh, it's steady on.
Dad said Christmas morning was for, like, you know, for me. So he used to stay in bed.
Mm.
So he never.
That's brilliant. That's a great thing to say, isn't it? Yeah, yeah. Christmas morning's for you. Run wild. Do what you want. Just don't bother me.
I'm going to Honolulu for 2 weeks.
That's great. Dad, it's Christmas. Do I have to do anything? No.
So my mum used to get up because she used to like to see my face light up, you know, when I open the presents. And then,
to give fireworks.
And then, then I'd have to go to my bedroom from about 6 o'clock onwards, because, like, my mum and dad were into having big Christmas parties, and I wasn't, like, old enough to go.
Right.
So they'd say, right, you know, you've had your fun there, you go up to your bedroom, stay in there.
And, really?
Yeah, I remember one year, right, I got a train set, that's what I wanted.
Yeah.
Right? Brilliant. Playing with it all day. I thought, I don't mind about the party, I'm happy staying up here, playing with this. Brother comes in. He's had a few, right? He's going, yeah, give us a go on your
train. How old is he?
He's a bit older than me, so he might have been like, let's see.
Well, let him be 18.
About, yeah, probably about 18, 19, something like that. I was, well, I had a train set, so I don't know, about
14.
Something like that, yeah. Right? So I'm playing on that, loving it and stuff. And then he comes in and goes, oh, give us a go. He turns the transformer up to like 14. He went really fast for about 5 seconds. Broke it, and then he went back downstairs.
Wow.
So Christmas, I hadn't even got to
Christmas
Day.
Sounds like the Conservative government with British Rail.
Satire, eh?
Rick, well, I just thought that then, satire. There's any satirical shows listening or magazines.
It doesn't work in any way, because there's the analogy falls down apart from there being a train.
Think it through, though. British Rail was trains.
Yeah.
And the government broke the trains in many ways. They didn't break them, like, not officially breaking them, but they kind of...
Yeah, it does work. It's perfect.
Oh, I'm pretty pleased with that.
And I can't... And no one's asked him to be on Have I Got News For You?
It's weird, isn't it?
Because
it's strange that when you've got a satirical mind that's as quick as that.
Yeah. All and right. It's broke your little train set. So what did you do?
I just like watched telly and had some sausages.
I bet you were happy with that though, weren't you?
It's just a bit annoying though, isn't it, when your main present of the year has been broke.
And did it ever get it fixed?
No, that was it. That was it. Put away.
I'm intrigued why your parents wouldn't let you come and join in the festive fun. Was it like really debauched down there? Was it like eggnog everywhere?
Well, no, but I mean, that's fair enough. 6 is a little bit early, but I just think, you know, if you're... Your kid, you know, he had his fun. Put him to bed at 8, maybe.
And you think so on Christmas Day? I thought that was a day for family.
Well, not if there's a party going on.
Don't have the party on to Christmas Day.
Well, that's another option.
Yeah. Your parents are weird, aren't they? A strange breed.
I've had a great time. Merry Christmas, everybody. I hope we haven't offended you by some of Carl's rantings. Just think of what he's gone through in his life. Victoria Plum incident.
Carl, I've got a little gift for you here before we go.
Oh, you're joking. I haven't got you anything.
Well, no, you haven't got your girlfriend anything. It's not exciting, but it's worth taking. In fact, why don't you just re-gift that straight away?
It's alright. Cheers for that.
It doesn't even look to it.
Champagne.
And that's not the champagne we got free from the BBC, is it?
It's not actually, no, Rick, because that is far too good for the likes of Carl.
Oh, right.
And I wasn't going to give it to him. You wouldn't appreciate it. That's just sparkling wine.
Oh, brilliant. Oh, I love that.
Yeah, he doesn't know the difference.
I'm seeing Carl on Christmas Day because he's around Christmas Day in London, so I'll get a little gift then, Carl.
Alright.
That'd be good, wouldn't it? It'd be a nice little...
Okay, answers. We must give the answers.
You would have to go to bed at 6, though, right. So we can play.
Right, here's the last clues of the year. You had, there's a load of letters there asking for advice. Put them on Claire's desk. That was for Foreigner. For Rainer.
I don't know what you mean.
Claire Rainer. She took advice. She gave people advice. So that's a Foreigner.
That is shit.
Right.
I'm sorry. That may be Christmas. That is absolute dark.
A lot of people got the right answer.
I know. Yeah, well, that annoys me even more.
Number 2. The second one, ask your mum.
Foreigner. Yeah. Foreigner.
Second one, ask your mum if you should. That was S. That was Shalimar.
Shalimar.
Shalimar. Right.
Now, bizarrely, what was the clue there?
Ask your mum if you should.
Now, we've got a lot of people saying Smashing Pumpkins as the answer to that. But I don't know who's saying that today, Mum. Smashing Pumpkins.
Merry Christmas, Mum. Smashing
Thanks
pumpkins.
Very much. Nice bollocks. <Right. laughs> Oh, that's great. That's great. Right. Smashing pumpkins. Your dad bought them for me for Christmas.
Yeah.
Ah.
And the last one.
Lovely plums.
What, my Victorias?
Oh, God.
Right, we've got to wrap it up. We've got to wrap it up.
Come on, then.
A couple of people were arguing in the supermarket at the fruit and veg counter. That was B. That was banana drama. They were, like, having an argument.
What do you mean banana drama? What, no, wait. What group is banana drama? What group is banana drama?
So.
You're a fool. You're a twat.
When you say that, but you accuse her, you accuse Carl of that. You're also accusing lots of the listeners, including the winner, yeah. Nicola Rogers, of London. And she wins those great prizes, and she got them bang on, so.
Banana drama.
So, can we finish there now?
Yeah. What do you mean, can we finish there now?
Just play the ads and go.
What?
No, what are you talking about? We're going to play Jamie Nicholas.
We've been practicing it all day. We'll play that then.
Goodness, we've got. Oh, look at you.
We haven't got time.
Merry Christmas, Carl.
Merry Christmas, Carl.
Alright.
Don't be nervous. We might see a difference in Carl. He's a little bit shy. There's someone here from the BBC filming this part of that celebrity boxing thing. The Fight, I think it's called. And they want to get a little clip of this. So we're going to. Let them film for a minute, and then they're going to go away. Is that all right, Carl?
Yeah.
He doesn't want to be on camera, do you? Do you?
I think it ruins radio, doesn't it?
Do you know not for the people listening, it doesn't.
Yeah, but it does, because people are like, oh, that, he sounds like a bit of a looker.
What, you?
Yeah. And then they'll see it on the telly, and they'll go, God, yeah, his head is round.
It is round, though, isn't it?
So.
Guess what? I got a call yesterday. You'll love this, Steve.
Mm.
From MTV, and wondering if they could screen test Carl.
That's outrageous.
I'm loving it, and I was going yeah, and I said yeah, it's fine. I come down with him, and I was saying what about this and that. They were loving it. I called him, and he went oh no. I went why not? He went well, I'm looking at my reflection now in the mirror. He said oh, I shouldn't be on the telly.
What would you wear for your screen test, Carl? What kind of look would you try and cultivate? Because you've got to bear in mind that the audience out there, they don't know what you look like. So, would you be a snappy dresser like, say, Jonathan Ross, or would you go for your kind of street cash look?
Can't wear a suit.
You can't wear a suit?
Don't hold it well.
Uh-huh.
So, I'm thinking, I don't know, I'll probably wear me woolly hat, because that takes some years off me.
It does, he looks about 10 with a woolly hat on.
Yeah.
Okay.
And,
is it quite a cool woolly hat, or has it got a bubble?
It's charcoal, I'd say it's the in colour.
Yeah, okay.
And I'll probably wear me anorak.
Right.
He's going for quite a glam look. Yeah. Oh,
no one
dressed
else
for
it.
A jumble sale. Wow.
But,
yeah.
But I'm not that happy about it all, to be honest.
Are you going to do it? You're not going to do it?
Well, I'm sort of stuck in the middle. Because throughout my life so far, I've never planned for anything, right? It's just always happened.
Yeah, yeah.
The time, you know what I mean? Being in plays at school, never planned it, but when I did it, I went down a storm.
It was a trial, yeah, we all remember that.
So.
As I remember, you did Little Donkey.
Did Little Donkey, yeah.
And then later, someone was filming at the back. Was it your dad's mate?
My dad's mate.
Yeah, and on the camcorder, he listened to it back, watched him playing it. His dad says, just off camera, what does he say?
I don't want to say it because I'm in charge of the show and I'd be irresponsible.
He looks like a right twat.
So,
and so he gets home, just watching that, and then here's his dad just off camera go, he looks like a right twat.
Yeah, alright, yeah.
What are you worried about? Your dad saying that
on
the
word. Can I just interject? Because I'm really worried about this idea of Carl being on MTV. Because the problem is that, you know, let's be honest, Rick. I mean, we're getting by the skin of our teeth, aren't we, really? It's only Carl that's keeping this afloat.
Yeah.
And if he gets on MTV and the world sort of gets a sense of him and they understand him, and he won't be ours anymore.
Simon and Garfunkel. April comes she will. Looking forward to spring already.
Yeah, it's a bit premature, but fine.
Well, I thought it'd be nice. Yeah. You know, it's a bit cold.
Get Christmas over first, all right?
Christmas over. I love that. My mum used to go, oh, that's not over for another year.
Yeah, yeah.
Like used to look forward to it all year. You know, buy things out of the catalogue, pay for it for the next 12 months, and they go, oh, that's not over now. Like, yeah. You know, 5 o'clock Christmas Day, that was it. When is Christmas over?
I would say Christmas is over once you've seen the Vicar of Dibley Christmas special.
Really?
Yeah.
See, I think it was earlier than that. I think it was when the elderly ones fall asleep about 3:30.
Really?
Then wake up because the kid's playing with something noisy.
Yeah.
A game that goes something
yeah,
like that.
Yeah, yeah.
That's when Christmas is over.
You know what you're getting this year then.
Exactly. I do. All right. I was shopping with Carl. I don't give anything away that I bought, right? Because it, you know. But I've got to tell you something. We went to this one shop. I didn't get anything from it, so I can talk about this, for looking for a present for my girlfriend, Jane. And it was a beautiful shop in St. James's. They're all beautiful around there. And, it was this shop of, sort of iconoclastic, sort of antiquities, and it was, things that, this guy, you had to ring a bell for the bloke to come down. Carl was just so confused about that. He's used to someone standing there going, can I help you?
Yeah.
What size do you want? Right, and he came down, and he loved his stuff. He absolutely loved his stuff.
And what sort of stuff was it?
It was sort of stuff that he'd, got from sort of like churches. It was carvings. It was from the 16th and 17th century of saints, right? And I said, this is beautiful. And I was talking to him. I said, what's this news going on? That so-and-so. I was going, oh, that's wonderful. Look at that. Right? And I overheard Carl trying to make conversation. He said to this guy, who's so proud of this stuff. And it's, you know, at 16th century, 17th century, he went, what's the newest thing you've got in here?
Brilliant.
And the bloke went, we've got a statue, I think. From the 60s of then, and he went, all right. He went, when was the last time you got something in? Bloke went, we get something in every day. And afterwards I said, why were you asking those questions? He was going, well, it always confused me with antiques. What happens when they sell that out? They're not making any more.
I just thought there's a sort of good business to get into, that's all. Do you know what I mean?
Why?
There'll always be antiques.
Well, you said it yourself. The place wasn't buzzing, was it? He had to pop down. He couldn't even be bothered sort of sat in the shop waiting for a customer because probably days go by and nothing's happening. Doesn't it? For you to ring the bell to wake him up to say, oh, I'll come and look at this old stuff. Forget it. You know what I mean?
So you've got all your Christmas shopping then, Carl? You're bang up to date. You don't?
Yeah, I've sorted, you know, most stuff out. But here's one for you, right? Here's a little question.
Go on.
Right, I've finished a job, right, where I've been working somewhere for like about 10 years.
You can say it.
No.
XFM, where we met.
It was a good little place to work and everything, but I've had enough. Yeah. You know what I mean, after 10 years.
You're moving on. We've got to move on, haven't we?
You've got to, you know, try.
We're on radio too.
Yeah, no, it's good.
Right, so you're moving on, yeah?
Right. And, so they gave me a present, right? They sort of said to me, what do you want?
Yeah.
You've done 10 years. Tell us what gift you want and we'll sort you out, right? So I said, oh, brilliant, yeah. So, I knew Suzanne, my girlfriend, wanted a camera.
No.
Right? Okay. They got me a camera, they wrapped it up and they, you know, like my leaving deal, they said open it and I go, no, I don't want to open it. No, what's going on? So, well, I'm going to give it to Suzanne for Christmas.
No,
Why?
That's a disgrace.
But why is it though?
You can't, because it's-
It doesn't matter because I could have had a gift for myself and I didn't, I decided-
You can't, no. That's secondhand.
It's not secondhand, it hasn't been used, I haven't even opened it.
But surely the point about buying a gift for your girlfriend is that you've gone in the shop and done it. There's a sentimental attachment.
That. It's not about that.
It is though. It is. No, it is about that.
It's about them getting what they want.
So if you're walking down the street and you saw a camera and it was brand new and you went, oh yeah, Suzanne, happy Christmas. So are you going to tell her it was a gift?
Well, no, she's at work today, so she doesn't need to know.
So you're not even going to tell her?
No point.
So you've got deceit as well as meanness.
Doesn't matter, does it? She's got what
that's
she wanted.
That's disgraceful. Okay, I want to get the people on the text. Do you think that Carl's in the right? 88291. It should Carl be giving a gift to his girlfriend, which he's passing
she's getting
his own present.
You cannot. The thing is, it would be okay if you were giving it to a mate or something, but I'd still tell them. I'd even say, look, I didn't pay for this, but I know you wanted a camera. Yeah. But you're not going to tell her, so she's going to think you spent 700 quid or something.
Well, 250.
he's not even a £700 free camera. she'll never think that I spent 700 quid on her.
That is brilliant. Well, it's an improvement on last year. Do you remember what you got last year?
I'd rather he told us.
Come on, what did you get? Your partner, your life partner,
your lover,
your last year for Christmas. How long have you been with her first?
11 years.
11 years. What did you get her last year for Christmas?
Some condoms.
I mean, that's unbelievable.
Bang up two packets.
Yeah, no, you bought her a big bumper packet of condoms from Boots or something, and you got one packet free.
Yeah. And they've all been used.
I said in the past to you, Rick, that my grandparents, so I love them dearly, but it's like for the last 30 years, they've been waiting to die.
I know.
It's like they just sort of, it's like, you know, the novelty wore off of like.
Life in the 50s.
Yeah, got kind of bored of it. Like, yeah, in the 40s, it was brilliant. All sat around the old Joannas, the Bob's Fail singing. They loved that. The 50s, you know, that was great as well, because that was the post-war years. It was, you know, it was a bit tight in the pocket, but it was all right. Everyone pulled together. And then the 60s came along, all the crazy music, the funny hair.
Let's stay in bed.
Exactly. And they basically stayed in bed. And it was one Christmas when my grandmother said to my dad, what do you like for Christmas? What do you fancy for Christmas? And this must have been
well, I don't know, 20 years ago. She said, what do you fancy for Christmas, Ron? And he went, well, you know, I could do with a nice big kind of warm winter overcoat. She said, don't worry about that. She said, don't worry about that, because your father will be dead soon. It's what you can have is. Meaning my granddad. Well, to be honest with you, my father's still waiting. Which is good news. Good news for my grandfather. Less good news for
he's
my dad.
He's freezing. He phones up, how is he today? He's fine. Yeah, okay. Oh, I'm freezing.
It is such a weird mindset, that. I think it's that, to me, is what sums up people from that older generation, the 40s and 50s. And it seems to me that you've got that kind of mindset. It's like you were born in the 30s. Whenever you talk of your childhood, it's like you had, like, a baked potato to take to school. And a stick as a Christmas
gift. The other thing is, I think that that sort of generation, it seems that the man is dependent on the woman.
Mm.
There's a total dependence.
Oh, absolutely.
If she dies, he's done.
Yes.
He's done for. It just pine away. If he dies, she's got 30 years of pottering.
Absolutely, yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
And going
to, like, you know, the youth club and the church.
Yeah, I know what you mean, yeah.
It's sort of like that. It's sad. Of course, it's sad for them, but it's not the end of their life.
No, sure.
And it sort of is the other way around. I don't know why that is.
Yeah.
It's terrible.
That's a little melancholy thought for Christmas.
I know.
You brought it down.
I've brought it down. This isn't a nice show at all. This is terrible.
We're going to have people just killing themselves.
What?
Well, I didn't really want to make it a Christmassy type show, because I don't really like it.
Oh, he's done it again. Well, you did Christmas once, didn't like it.
No, it's just...
Play a record.
No, I'm not religious or anything.
What are you? You're not anything.
Walk Out to Winter, Aztec Camera, before that, The Pretenders, it's Ricky Gervais' show, but I'm here, Steve Merchant, Carl Pilkington's here. Right. Christmas Eve, Radio 2, Merry Christmas.
Producer just came in and said, oh, can you give out the web address, bbc.co.uk/radio2. I went, yeah, why? He said, well, just in case people want to listen to this show again.
Yeah, right.
Oh.
He's got a sense of humour.
Yeah, as if. So, Carl, we've had loads and loads of emails.
We should just, in case you've just tuned in, Carl received a leaving gift of a digital camera when he was leaving a job, and he's not even unwrapped it, he's giving it straight to his girlfriend for tomorrow, which... I think Ricky and I
are fairly special. And he's not going to tell her it was free, and he thinks there's nothing
wrong. It wasn't free. It was 10 years of my life I had to do that.
Yeah, and you've been 11 with us. Think what she's gone through. She's had 11 years of her life. Right. Wow. You know, Carl would have been okay if he'd have kept quiet. Idiot. Dave in Salford. Jeez. He's right. Mm-hmm. Yeah, he's right. It's a disgrace. He has dishonoured his former employer and his girlfriend from Graham and Anna. That's a good point. It's an insult to the people that work there. They got you something they thought they really liked. They really went out and thought about it. They wrapped it up. You didn't even unwrap it in front. Because you couldn't be bothered to wrap it again, even. You could have unwrapped it. Do you know what, I really hope's happened? That before they gave it to you, they took pictures of their genitals in the toilet as a little away. So your girlfriend's gonna get that and get loads and loads and loads of pictures of offal from people who work at XFM. That would be the best Christmas gift for me.
What if there's a note or something inside that they've all written and signed to Carl?
Look, he's thinking about that. Look, that is the first time he's ever thought of that. Look at his head. Look at his
Christian
head.
Hull says, I think Carl's heart is in the right place. Don't know about his brain, though.
Good point.
A fair point.
There's one here. I once got a frozen box of fish my husband found whilst working in the chip shop. Carl's girlfriend should be grateful. Yeah, I suppose so. It's staggering.
It's one from Jane. It says, better his girlfriend has the camera, as it looks like he hasn't got opposable thumbs. And that's people having a dig. They don't even know you.
But you know why I'm not a sort of big fan of sort of Christmas and buying presents and that anyway? Because I've had bad experiences in the past. When, like, you know, buying stuff for people.
Go on.
You know, like, when I was a kid and that, right?
Yeah.
And, you know, you put a lot of thought into buying presents, don't you, when you're a kid? Because, you know, you haven't got that much money to...
How old are we talking?
About 8.
Right, okay.
Yeah. About 8, right?
So you look like you did, but you had hair, I assume?
Yeah, right. So, 8 years old and that, I'm putting a bit of planning into it, thinking, oh, you know, what will my mum want, right? Now, my mum's a big fan of, gnomes.
Right, obviously.
Like gnomes. Gnomes.
She must be pleased how you turned out.
And fairies and stuff like that, right? Little elves and all that stuff, right?
Sure.
So I thought, right, I'll look for something that's a bit gnomish. Right. And there was
a
shop.
You got a Noel Edmonds.
There was this shop sort of down the road that, sort of sold a lot of tat, right?
Yeah. Oh, good.
sort of every, you know, one of them shops where everything's quite cheap, it's sort of, they sell things individually that shouldn't be, like toilet rolls and That sort of thing.
They used to be called everything's a pound. Now they're saying that everything's 99p. Because a pound wasn't cheap enough.
They're undercutting the pound job. Go on.
So anyway, so I had a look in there, thinking, right, let's have a look, see if they've got any gnomes and that. And the closest thing they had, right, was this figure that's called Victoria Plum.
Right? Victoria Plum, right.
Yeah, it's like a little woman.
No, Victoria Plum. Right, get it right.
It's like a woman gnome. Right.
Okay.
So I thought I should love that. Right. So save it. I think it was about £2. Right.
Yeah.
Invest in one of them. Take it home and well chuff with myself and that. Wrapping it up. Pop it under the tree. Think I can't wait to see her face light up when she sees this.
Aww.
Yeah.
Anyway, do you know like when you're a kid? I bought that like 2 weeks before Christmas.
Sure.
Right. And do you know when you're sort of excited and you want to give someone a present earlier?
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I sort of took my mum into this shop. Right. And we're just walking about, and the Victoria Plum was sort of there on the shelf. And I said to her, I said, oh, I said, look at that up there, do you like that? She said, no, it's bloody horrible, right? So this is too late, it's too late to go back.
Money's spent,
it's wrapped, it's under the tree, right? I'm thinking, oh, I can't believe it. So I said, no, that, you know, made sure she's looking at the right thing. I said, no, that little gnome woman, yeah, it's horrible.
Oh, no.
Yeah, oh, right?
Oh, God!
Christmas Day comes, right? Yeah. I open my stuff, right? She's about to open
really
hers.
Sad. This is like Dickens.
She opened She opened hers and that, and she went, oh, that's lovely, that. I said, no, don't give me that. Do you know what I mean? You said
she thought she was a liar.
Yeah.
For pretending, for not wanting to hurt your feelings. She was a liar.
And that's, you know, that's why, you know.
But things have moved on.
What are you on about? Yeah, but you don't forget, do you?
I still don't know how this justifies you not buying your girlfriend of 11 years an actual gift.
Although that was quite touching.
Yeah.
Play a Christmas song, I'm welling up.
What? Are you not in the Christmas spirit?
Why didn't you enjoy last Saturday?
What did you do?
I went all the way back up north again, right? Because it was Suzanne's dad's birthday. Right? I was busy last week, didn't have time to get him a present or anything.
Didn't have time to give him a present.
So I got to Euston Station, bought a card for him, which was a Christmas card, so he wasn't happy because he was saying it's my birthday, and I said, well, I won't be seeing you again. So I've got a joint card. And then we went out.
Did you get him a present?
Well, no, because we went out on Saturday night for something to eat at this pub that he likes. It's a nice steak and onion rings, right?
Lovely.
So he should have been happy anyway.
Yeah.
But.
Well, you paid for it?
No, no.
But he should have been happy anyway.
Suzanne paid for that because it is her dad, right? Not mine. So I said, all right, what can I do? I said to her. So she said, just buy a few drinks or something. Anyway, I didn't get around to getting drinks.
Cause
I can't believe it.
Right, so I said, right, I'll pay for the cab, right?
Oh, what a lovely Christmas gift that is.
Yeah, £2.50.
I paid, no, it was like three quid back.
So 6 quid you spent on him?
Well, no, I spent more. See, that's what he said.
You get the Bolton and back, kind of, for that.
He said, oh, you've spent on me 6 quid for my birthday. I said, no, I haven't, because I gave the taxi driver a tip.
I'm a little bit worried about his attitude as well. Because even if, I mean, that is a stingy present, but you don't say.
I mean, let's be honest, that's the worst Christmas gift ever, because, I mean, you're pretty bad, like we discussed in the past, but at least you spend a bit of money.
Yeah.
It's just thoughtless.
Yeah.
This is nothing.
I know.
You're giving him any time. I mean, I would.
And I knew my demographic. They loved it, my family.
They
couldn't believe their luck. You know.
Well, a tenner.
You spent a tenner on him?
Well, the cab fare was 6 quid.
But the thing is, I don't think he's saying that. I think it's the fact that this is like, you know, frittering away in everyday life.
Kind of thoughtless.
He would have loved to, I'm sure he would have been appreciative of a lovely £10 gift that you cared about and bought a book. He probably likes Fly Fishing, doesn't he, by J.R. Hartley. Mm-hmm. If you'd have bought that, he'd have gone, that's what I was looking for.
Well.
Or E, what I was looking for, Carl. E, bloody hell, Carl, you little bald twat. That's just what I wanted. So, all right, so just calm down.
So what have you got planned for Christmas? Is this what, I mean, are you doing the same
Christmas? Oh, Carl, excellent. You've paid me milk bill for this week. That were really nice.
I'm spent this year.
So have you planned anything for Suzanne, or are you just
I'm taking her out Christmas Day for something to eat.
Well, right. Does she know that?
She's working today, so she, you know.
Right, okay.
So what Christmas gift have you got?
That's it, I'm taking her out.
What, you haven't got a present?
No, because we've spent a lot.
Don't forget, that's half yours, though. You're going to be eating. You're not going to just be sitting there watching her eat, going, oh, I'm hungry, but I spent all of it. You're going to be eating as well. That's half yours.
So you've got. She's got nothing to unwrap.
It looks like a cat who's been hit.
She's got nothing to unwrap. There's nothing. She's going to hand something over to you, because I've met the woman. She will. She'll hand something over, you'll open it, you'll love it.
I might get something today.
But you shouldn't take me to begrudgingly persuade you to do it.
God.
Hey, so. I should just point out, because it's Christmas time, we've had an email from Dickie Anderson.
Oh, Dickers.
RA is, well, he's I suppose he's a long time listener.
Yeah.
And he emails us most weeks. Ricky. If, as I suspect, I'm your only listener, I wouldn't bother with your show today, as I've got to attend some family Christmas nonsense at Auntie Marion's house. That's from Dickie Anderson, and he's good because considering he hates the show and everything we stand for, he does take the time to email every week.
That counts to advertisers.
Yeah.
I think we've got a lot like him. We've also had a lovely Christmas card here from Alexandra, right? Who's wishes she loves the show. She loves you, Carl, and she's enclosed some biscuits for you to save you a bit of money because she knows you goes out and get your own biscuits. Then we've got some lovely little packet of Fox's
Creations.
Well,
why don't you wrap them up and you can give them to your girlfriend? Rick Waller, you'll be pleased. Now, I'm a huge Rick Waller fan. Not only has he got a great singing voice, but he really is a picture. Isn't he? No, I know it's a bit harsh. I've said it before, but he does make me a little sick to the stomach when I look at Rick Waller. To be honest with you, it's his own fault. You know, he went in Celebrity Fix. Like, he had a chance to sort things out, and his attitude was wrong, and he didn't trim down. And he's, for want of a better phrase, a bloater and slightly grotesque. But, you know, he's in the paper this week saying that it was all because of his image. He didn't fit the stereotype of what pop stars should look like, blah, 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 blah. Well, he's disgruntled by this. He's got a great singing voice.
Well, he has got a great singing voice.
But the point is this, Rick. The point is this. Since the days of Elvis, since the days of Bing Crosby...
He's not as bad as Elvis.
But you're a star because you have to have the whole package. The voice, the sex appeal, everything. We know how it works. Kids buy it. It's pop music. That's what pop music is.
Mm.
You know, if you want to be a big fat bloater, you've got to at least be as good as Barry White. He isn't.
Or Pavarotti.
And so anyway, he set up an organisation. He's already got a band. You know, he's got
a band. You're saying, get over it. The world should revolve around looks.
Well, no, I'm saying pop music. That's what pop music is. I mean, this kind of obsession with he should get a chance.
But
not
on record.
No, I know, but be a backing singer. The point is this kid wants to be a star. He wants to be a star, doesn't he? That's the point. He doesn't want to sing and make a couple of records. He just wants to be a star.
I'd have thought that's the real rub, that actually he's not being truthful with himself.
Yes.
He doesn't just want to make beautiful music and sing well. He wants to be, you know, carried around on a sedan chair and adored.
Imagine that.
I know. He'd have to have a lot of money to pay for the entourage that can carry him.
Yeah, the four elephants needed. But he's got a company now. He set it up with his dad. It's a management company. It's called Star Search. And basically, he's hoping to break the fickle industry, expectations. And so if you're a bit of grotesque, if you're a freak of some kind, if you're someone that Carl, you know, would be impressed by or, alarmed by, then you can get in touch with Rick and he can put you in there. Women with beards, little midget fellas, whatever. Whatever it does not fit the usual norm.
Should we cut along?
I'm thinking the three of us next week. We won't have much to do after next week.
Mm.
You know, Ricky's got a bit of a singing voice on him. I'm learning to play Blowing in the Wind on the keyboard by Bob Dylan.
Yeah.
So I can master that. I don't know what you can do.
You can dance. You can dance, can't you? You know that. You've done it. You've done dancing, so.
Exactly.
It's like, you
little
know.
Little Donkey. We'll have a hit at Christmas.
Perfect.
I'm good at that.
What were you meant to be playing when you did Little Donkey in the play?
Drums to We Three Kings.
But you just busted live, didn't you?
We've done that. We're just talking about looks and stuff, right?
Always.
Because, it sort of cheeky freak of the week, we did that and I stopped doing it.
Sure.
It was upsetting a few people.
Mm-hmm.
There was a thing on the website the other day about Elephant Man, right? Just keeping up to... You know, up on the news, what's going on there? And
Drunkie news.
They did a thing about him and what he'd look like if his head wasn't messed up.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And they made a little picture for him.
Was he quite good looking?
Not bad looking, but you can't use it. It's not like you can't put it on a passport.
Sure.
And the fact that he's been dead for several years.
Yeah.
No, but they also do that sort of thing for people who are alive. They say, this is what you look like. So you can't use it for that.
Yeah.
You can't use it.
That's sort of like rubbing it in, though, isn't it, really?
It is a bit.
Yeah. Unless they said, good news, you were ugly anyway.
Yeah.
To be quite honest.
You wouldn't have pulled if you didn't look like an elephant.
If you were symmetrical, you weren't a looker.
You couldn't use it on a little dating agency picture. This is what I look like.
This is what I would have looked like. And they phone up and go, I'm intrigued. What do you mean would have looked like? Well, I see you, as we said, 7 o'clock. How will I recognise you? I'll be eating buns.
Yeah, look for the giant cauliflower.
yeah, in a coat.
exactly.
I love the fact that you're keeping up to date with what the Elephant Man might have looked like.
yeah, exactly.
That is amazing.
Carl's news is largely what's happening in around 1880.
Yeah, or what might have happened exactly, around 1880.
No, but it's sad, though. Did you watch that thing in the week, that What Are You Staring At programme?
I didn't know. I couldn't face it. I know what you mean. It was about people who'd had unfortunate deformities.
Yeah, and it was really sad. I suddenly felt bad about, you know, some of the stuff we'd talked about and what have you.
Just say something like that's quite a nice thing to say. I suddenly felt bad about some of the things we talked about. Should we go over what we've discussed today?
What
subjects have we brought up today? How can you feel sorry about things like that when we're still doing it?
No, I'm just saying, you know, you have a laugh and that, but then you see a programme about it and you go, oh.
What, you realise they're real people you're talking about?
Yeah.
When do you ever forget that? When do you ever forget that when you bring up these cheeky freaks of the weeks, or when we talk about Rick Waller, that there's not a real person on the other end thinking about it?
Yeah, but sometimes it's hard because they don't look like real people.
Play a record!
Don't slag off Rick Waller.
That girl was on with a big head. It's like bow selector.
Letter to Hermione, David Bowie. Well, we've had the most convincing answer, that it's about 290,000 actual words, but possibly 3 million in our vocabulary, using all jargon and scientific stuff and all that.
Sure.
290,000. Still a lot, isn't it?
It is a lot.
We know so little, don't we?
Apparently the average person has about 20,000 words in their vocabulary, right, and uses maybe 2,000 a week.
Really?
Yeah. Carl, obviously, slightly bringing that average down.
Carl, look at that.
Single figures.
What's the matter? Get by. Why have you got to use longer words messing about and that? Told you. That word about old. Anti-dipoean or something. Just say old. That's a bit old, isn't it? That's a bit anti-dipoean and that. What's the point?
Yeah.
Get to the point.
Sure.
Busy.
Right, okay. Are you in a film this week, Carl?
We doing that now?
Yeah, go on. Get it over with.
Hang on a minute, then.
Get it over with. Let's get this show over with. We can go home. You can go off to Lanzarote and sit on some ash.
Some charcoal.
He's not happy about that. That's annoyed him. The listeners have all ganged up on him.
Yeah.
XFM giving him 2 CDs.
We've had more calls for his resignation this week than ever before.
What do you think of that, Carl?
What do you mean?
There's another reason.
Do you know what I mean, though? Because he's grumpy, he's not just giving it. He goes, well, I can't have it, can I? I don't want it. You're being paid well to do a job. People have tuned in to be entertained, to have good songs. Me and Steve are working.
I'm pressing
here.
The buttons. I'm paid to press the buttons. That's what I'm doing. Has every CD started on time?
Then
yeah.
Why would they give you Monday off if you just paid to press the buttons?
Don't get every other Monday off, do I?
So have you stopped doing that now, have you?
Well, yeah.
Why?
Because there's work to do in that. But I'm not moaning about it. Let's get on with it. Right, Scrooge, right, is the film that I'm in. Thought I'd do a Christmassy one.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah.
Get people in the Christmas mood and that.
Yeah, you have, yeah. You have got people in the Christmas mood. You're like Santa visiting them.
Right. So.
You in the film Scrooge?
Yeah.
Which version of Scrooge?
The old one.
Is it if it's just you moaning with bells, I'll be annoyed. Right,
that
on,
is
then.
Essentially Scrooge.
yeah.
Right, Scrooge, listen to this and then there's some question at the end.
All right.
And you can win some stuff and that.
Yeah.
Alright.
Yeah.
You're late.
Only 20 minutes.
What do you mean by coming in here at this time of day,
I've just been doing some Christmas shopping, haven't I? Probably do some more shopping on Monday, because it's my day off, isn't it?
Yes, I know it is. You don't have to tell me.
Got to see what I've bought, Suzanne?
No, thank you.
I don't mind showing you. It's only a Christmas present, isn't it? Bought some more condoms.
Why?
Well, I bought some last year. Got 2 boxes. They all got used, so.
I'm very glad to hear it. How much do I pay you?
why are you asking? The presents I buy has got nothing to do with what I earn. Like I say, if I won the lottery, I wouldn't go mental on her. Do you know what I mean? I probably wouldn't even tell her because I think she'd want to travel around the world and all that, and I'm not into that, to be honest, so I'd probably keep it quiet.
Why?
Well, once you've been around the world, where do you go next year? Each to their own, though, isn't it? You know what I mean?
Well, what do you want?
What for Christmas? Not that fussed, really. And you, it's just as well I'm not that fussed, because do you know I do some work at XFM? Do you know what they're giving me for Christmas present?
Nothing.
No, might as well have been nothing. Two CDs. That's it. I was well fed up.
I'm sure you were.
They give you a list of about 30 albums and you get to pick two off the list. So I've gone for Kings of Leon album and the Best of Bob Marley.
Mr. Marley has been dead these 7 years. In fact, he died 7 years ago this very day.
Did he? Do you know what sort of donuts Bob Marley likes?
It's not my business.
It's not a proper question. It's an old Peter Kay joke. He likes the ones with jam in. Do you get it? Garlic bread. It's good, isn't it?
Excellent.
Carl, oh man.
Carlene Scrooge there. the only man more mean and depressed generally than Ebenezer Scrooge.
Oh dear. Oh.
What's the question, Carl?
Well, if people have been listening from the start, right, what albums am I getting? Yeah. Is that good?
Mm-hmm. Good, yeah.
What albums am I getting from, for working for this place for 6 years? Alright?
Ricky Dr. Gervais at xfm.co.uk. Sweet music.
I feel like you've never kind of enjoyed the wonder of Christmas. I don't think I can ever get the sense, maybe except when you were very, very young. You know, that kind of bright eyed, you know, thinking of Santa, you know, kind of landing on the roof and coming down the chimney and drinking the sherry or whatever.
I like the idea of it, right? Sure. The sort of, you know, I used to get a couple of annuals every year, you know.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Totally not, yeah.
And I was allowed to open one on Christmas Eve.
Oh, that's brilliant.
Just,
yeah, so... so they could throw it on the fire.
I think
quick skim through, do the work, so
yeah, I think that's a light of cigar off the cooker.
No, well, the thing is, right, you were just saying about what are you, about Christmas. That's the funny thing, right, because in our house, there's no one who's religious, right?
No.
My dad got annoyed when I went to church that day. He was like, what are you doing that for?
Of course.
I went to see a gig in Liverpool. Remember the band The Christians?
Yeah.
He thought I'd join some club.
Yeah.
I said, I've been to see The Christians. He was saying to me, man, what's he doing going out with them?
Yeah, yeah.
And then the other thing is, because I'm not christened or anything, my mum used to say to me, don't tell anyone that, because there's witches and stuff.
I want to go back and see his upbringing. I just want to go back and see him at 7. One day in the life of Carl,
just,
age 7.
Just to have three ghosts visiting tonight. And take him back through time.
But we could go with him. We could be some of the ghosts.
Yeah, so the ghosts of Christmas past. Oh, remember this?
That's incredible. So she wasn't Christmas, but she thought maybe someone could take your soul because you weren't christened.
It's like there's cults and that, isn't there? And if they find out you're not christened, then.
Right. So I don't think they care. I don't think a lot of cults care.
Well,
but what can they do if you're not Christian?
I don't know. I just said all right, because then through that time there must have been a time when.
But hold on, now they know.
Yeah, but I'm older now, so I'm all right. She used to worry about me playing out on the street.
Oh, she was worried about when you were naive and stupid and easily led.
Well,
yeah. Yeah. No. Good point. No, you're right now. Yeah.
So.
Yeah. Good.
It's after Christmas now. That's it for another year. All right, everyone had a nice Christmas?
Oh, yeah, I had a blinder. I had an absolute blinder, mate.
Good presents, Carl?
Yeah, not bad, yeah.
Get anything good? Odds and ends.
Not that I can think of.
Odds and salts.
Bits and bobs.
Yeah.
A
friend of mine got a gift, or rather gave it as a gift. I don't know if you've been familiar with these. It's a charity organisation, and you go on their website, or you know, phone them up, and you can give someone else the gift of, say,
a goat for an African family. So you say, this is what I've bought. I've bought goat. Yeah. And they go, oh, brilliant, where is it? And you go, no, it's going to a family in Africa. And it's a sort of goodwill thing, you know what I mean?
So you buy an African family a goat.
That will help them for years.
And it's like you're saying, well, I would have bought you a present.
Yeah. But I've used that money wisely.
Yeah, so it's almost like they've given
exactly
the present. They've given the goat.
Yeah, it's a beautiful idea. But as soon as he told me about it, I thought to myself straight away, knowing Carl's views on charity and giving, you know, particularly this seasonal time, I wondered what his views would be. Well,
are they happy with the present over there? Like the people who are getting it?
What, the African family?
Yeah. Is the African family sort of going, oh, I hope someone gets us a goat?
That's nothing to do with Christmas for them. They're not sitting around thinking, I wonder if Santa brings us some food. It's a long-term thing. These are happening all year, I assume. It goes towards a pool of money that goes to... It's not like they get a... You're an idiot. What, you think an African family wakes up and there's a little goat with a ribbon tied around it and they go, oh, look what Santa brought us.
Look, and that mince pie's gone and that glass of milk.
You're such an idiot.
No, but what I'm saying is, does that family want a goat?
Yes.
But why?
It's not that they want a goat, it's they need a goat. Do you think... this organisation is?
They're
going to say, oh, I wanted Nintendo. What are you thinking?
But what I'm saying is, right, let me put myself in their shoes.
Well, this will be a first.
Got any. But say I'm one of them, right, over there, right? I'm hungry, right? I'm sat there, it's Christmas Day, right? I open it up, open the present, little goat there, right? Now, if I was one of them, I'd be going, not another mouth to feed. At the end of the day, there isn't enough food to go round for themselves, never mind a goat. Don't they say, like, having a dog and that is quite expensive? Sometimes they say, you know, what with all the injections you've got to give it, the food, the tin food and everything, it mounts up. And what I'm saying is, that's all very well giving them a goat. Who's looking after it?
Well, I'm assuming it's all above board. The goat's had its injections. That's what some of the money goes towards. It's given to them so they can milk it and have milk and cheese and whatever. I don't think it's a burden. What do you mean? They wake up Christmas Day and open a present. It's not like that.
So there's a thing. There's a goat-shaped thing in wrapping paper. I wonder what that could be. I hope it's that goat we asked for. My God, it is.
All I'm saying
it's just a nice marketing way of distributing wealth. It's the way of going, this is a nice gift. It's like people sometimes they say, don't send flowers at a funeral. They don't send flowers. Give some money to the local hospice. Yeah. It's just a way of redirecting cash.
But the thing is, why do they want that goat? What's the main reason? What does a goat give you?
Milk.
Right. Now, wouldn't it be easy to just send them a bottle of milk? Without all the hassle and the headaches that come with it. That's all I'm saying. And the other thing is, think about the goat. That was happy over here. Suddenly, it's on barren land. No grass.
I'm gonna burst! What do you mean?
He didn't send a goat from here.
I'm saying, who's happy at the end of this, right? You've got a fella who hasn't got a present over here because the mate bought him a goat, right? So, let's do this. Let's do this properly. So there's a tick. He's not happy, right? Then, you've got the person who's opened it, who, like you said, wanted something else, right? It's a goat. They go, who's going to look after this, right? So tick, they're not happy. And then you've got the goat going, what am I doing here?
Seth Lakeman and Fight for Favour, one of my favourite songs of the year. Isn't that beautiful?
It's very nice, yeah, I've not heard it before.
On Radio 2.
Ricky Gervais, Steve Merchant, Carl Pilkington, Christmas Eve. You know that already, I don't know why I'm
We're giving
that.
Gifts. We're giving the gift of song.
Yeah.
And chat.
The gift of chat, the gift of rockbusters.
The gift of
gobbledygook.
The gift of Carl.
Yeah.
To the nation. You cannot buy that. You can't bottle it.
I'd like to see him bottled.
That'd be ideal.
Like a little frog.
Pickled in a jar.
Yeah, exactly, yeah. He will be one day. He will be in Ripley's.
Yes.
One day.
Yeah.
And they say he used to walk round amongst us.
Exactly.
It's quite normal. But let's not forget why we give gifts.
Just to cheer people up in that.
Yeah. No, it's because the wise men gave gifts to the baby Jesus.
Yeah. Yeah.
So, that's why.
What would you have got the baby Jesus? I'd have probably got him tokens. and let him decide, because he's very, you know what I mean, you don't want to get anything, you know, and then he doesn't like it, wants to take it back.
Well, I'll tell you, in a recent poll Waterstones did, the favourite gift for children was flannimals. Still available.
That's so outrageous. That's so disgraceful. It's Christmas Eve.
What would you have got in then?
Probably extras on DVD. I don't make any money from flannimals.
Yeah.
I like the fact that one of the wise men turned up with gold. And the other two, frankincense and myrrh, which as I understand it is what, some, it's like incense or something? Incense or perfume?
I don't know.
I believe that's what it is. But I just love the idea that one of them turned up. They've all got together, they've gone, okay, now guys, we're not gonna spend more than 50 quid each this year, alright?
Definitely not.
So what have you all got? Before we go in and see him, what have you all got?
I spent a bit more than 50.
What are you talking about, man? We just say we weren't spending- We were just gonna have a whip round him cheap, like just, a token.
No, I got him some gold.
Can't believe it, what?
Well, I'm trying to make an impression, he's the son of God!
But I did- no, what, but what, I, we only got Frank- what, I got frankincense.
And what did the other fella get?
He got myrrh, and that's I don't even know what that is, and I'm a wise man. He'd have been, surely one of them must have been furious.
Is myrrh still popular? Gold still very popular.
Oh, I hope so, because this is what my gran's getting this year.
Really?
Yeah, lovely.
Well, that's why we give gifts.
Do you know why, how he got them gifts? Right?
Yeah.
Little baby Jesus.
Yeah.
Were they for Christmas or his birthday?
I don't know.
Radio.
Tell you what a lot of people are wondering, Carl, is what I received from Ricky this year.
Go on.
Nothing! Absolutely nothing. I remember actually after my birthday he said, oh yeah, I'll be getting you a little gift. Forgot. So I've had nothing from him this year. He's a man, he's got a little bit of cash in his pocket now. What I'm hoping is that maybe he'll pool it over the next 5 years and buy me something I've been reading about recently. Now, you definitely love this, surely. Have you started seeing this now? Virgin are starting plugging Virgin Galactic. I think it's something like 200,000 quid, and you'll get a chance to go in a space shuttle into space. Now, I don't know what your feelings are, Rick. You know, I know you've probably got a bit of cash in the bank.
I was, honestly, I was thinking of giving you another signed extras DVD.
Anything. It's the thought that counts, so okay. That would be great, but-
Because I've got some knocking round, I can give you one of those. I know you've already got one of those, but sure. I don't mind, they don't cost me much.
No, great.
And do you like the book Flannimals?
I know it's aimed at 5-year-olds, so I don't know why I personally would want it, but-
But, you know, that's gonna be in the little-
Yeah.
Little selection box for you.
Great.
Carl, it was in Heat this week, and, they mentioned that he does this thing on Sky. What is it?
It was this thing with Richard Bacon, some programme about watching telly, and you just talk about what you're watching, and that.
And he was annoyed, because he said, because his parents are out, and so he's not doing it. He's not gonna turn up, because they mentioned it in Heat.
And so his parents might watch?
Yeah.
Why are you worried about that?
I don't like him watching stuff, do I? I told you. It dates back to when I did Little Donkey at school. Sure. I don't want people watching me.
What's that? Just renew us on Little Donkey? What happened?
It was just, you know, I was there to play the drums and that, in We Three Kings. I was loving it, you know. I got a bit carried away.
How old were you?
About 13, right? Yeah,
really?
Probably.
Yeah.
About 10, no, about 10 probably.
Yeah.
Six.
Between 6 and
13. Where old were you? What school were you at?
okay, you were playing Little Donkey.
Yeah. No,
but it was one of them schools where everyone sort of was in the same one. Do you know what I mean?
Oh, a Manchester school.
Just what the one do you classroom. Mean?
Well, it's like you-
What, sweeping chimneys in the day and then 1 hour of learning? Yeah. What are you talking about? What school were you at? Was it infants, junior or secondary?
They didn't really do that. It was
what,
one
what
way-
What do you mean? You did that! They still have to abide by the laws of the land in Manchester!
No, but it was a lot more- Like you had infants, but you also had, like, the older lot. There's kids there- When you're in the younger year and that, you'd see kids and
talk,
you go, is that-
Talk English and use terms that people do when they're talking about schooling.
I don't even want to talk about this.
No, how old were you? What
I'm thinking- I'm guessing maybe 6 or 7 or 8.
So you went from 13 to 6?
Yeah, but like I say, it's hard to remember because-
Imagine if you were giving evidence in a trial.
Yeah. How old were you? I don't know.
Yeah.
I mean, I can't really narrow it down other than 7 years either way.
You know, theoretically,
yeah.
He could get called up for jury service. Right, you're on.
Freak of the Week's coming up now.
Oh, cheeky Freak of the Week.
Right, well,
We've had some interesting things we've been looking at. This week, it's about the strangest couple that ever got married.
And we've had two sets of chimps, yeah. So it's stranger than that. Oh, it's not Dale Winton and Mel McAndrew,
is it? It's not your parents, is it?
Well, we're going back again to about, I think this is about 19,
something like that.
1940.
Yeah,
yeah,
whatever.
Strangest couple, a fella, right? He had skin of a lizard.
He had the skin of a lizard, okay.
And the woman
which
he married.
Which he used as a condom.
The woman who he married.
Yeah.
Airiest woman ever.
Right.
And that was their act. They used to, tour the world. And they'd say, you know, it's like, you know, couple who've met, they're having a great life. Let's get them out on stage, here they are. And they'd,
what do you mean he had a skin of a lizard, first of all?
That's what it said, he had some sort of, some illness.
So he was called Lizard Man, and you liked that, because it was good description.
I thought that's good.
I'm here, hello, we've booked a table for two, who are you meeting? I'm meeting Lizard Man. Oh, he's over there.
Yeah.
You know he is, right?
Yeah.
I'm meeting the hairiest woman in the world. She's over there.
Yeah.
Yeah. So what did they do for their act?
Now, bear in mind that we had some Siamese twins last week and their act was having a bath.
Yeah, yeah.
So I hope it's an improvement on that.
What did Lizard Man? He came out and ate some flies, did he?
I don't really know. I just think they stood there on that.
Yeah, when you read this and it goes the most interesting fact ever. Lizard Man, and you go, that's enough, yeah, well, I can extrapolate from that.
But straight away I start thinking, I'm thinking, right, I wonder if they got the wedding photos. And then, like you said, that they had a kid.
Oh, what would that be like?
Exactly, it'd be like
an ostrich, wouldn't it?
That's what I was thinking.
What did you think it would come out like, the baby?
I didn't think what that looked like, I just was thinking, oh, parents' evening.
You wouldn't want him coming up to the school, would you?
So little Johnny, who starts off relatively normal, he's quite good at, you know, he's good at nature,
yeah,
isn't he? And his mum and dad come into the room and they'd be looking around, wouldn't they?
Well, it's always like that thing at school when, like, you find out your mate's mum and dad are really old.
Right,
have you
sure.
ever seen that?
Yeah.
When you go, have you your gran and granddad bought you?
Yeah.
You know, mum and dad. Yeah. And you go, oh.
It is weird.
What's that we're talking about? He calls him mum. What was that? Oh, sorry.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, and no, that's always strange. If you had Godzilla and King Kong as your parents,
yeah,
and they're always fighting, and you know, like you say, if you're in a school play or something, you wouldn't tell them, would you? You wouldn't want him coming out with a video camera.
He didn't tell his parents he was in that. When we were,
well, exactly.
You did Little Donkey, and you didn't tell your dad, did you? And he came along and videoed it.
Yeah, kept it quiet. Don't want him to know anything.
But you didn't. What was it? It was meant to be playing. You had a little drum, didn't you?
Yeah, I was doing. I had a little drum. I think it was meant to be playing We Three Kings.
Yeah.
But, we started doing Little Donkey and I thought, I can add a touch to this.
Sure, you improvised.
Started playing along with
it. It was like the first remix, wasn't it?
It went down well. But yeah, that's all I was thinking with, the Freak of the Week this week. That's what I'm saying about Freak of the Week. It's to get people thinking, right? Thinking how lucky they are that, you know, they don't have to...
comb their face. What are you talking about? What do you mean, Freak of the Week is to let people know how lucky they are?
Just...
What about the little freak you're talking about? What are they thinking? They're going, oh, he's talking about me. I'm a little hairy lizard man on a stick.
Pop in, give us a call. That's what I'd like to do on a TV programme. That's what I want to do. I want to go and, like, meet these people and say, right, let's just go shopping, let's... You know, we'll film what your normal day's like.
Yeah.
Let's pop out. Christ. Nip into Sainsbury's or whatever.
Yeah.
You know, buy a comb.
Park right up close to it.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah. So what you're saying is you just want to get a little message out there, which is that there's always someone worse off than you.
Well, there's proof of that in this room. You know what I mean?
Oh, Carl, when's your train?
In a minute. I'm going to get going now. I'll see you later.
Thanks, Carl.
Right. Brilliant. What are you planning to play a song?
Kirsten McCall.
Yeah.
I'll see you later.
Cheers.
Oh, chimpanzee that, monkey news.
Right, well, I thought we'd go for sort of a Christmas feel. Right.
So, this one, it's, it happened in Stockholm, right, a couple of years ago, around the Christmas time. It was this little grotto, right?
Oh, everything wow. he says is funny, yeah. isn't it?
A little grotto was set up and stuff, right, and, it was getting busier and busier, right, this little grotto. There was only one in Stockholm, right? Queue was massive and stuff.
Well, that's not true.
And this,
that's not true. There's
no,
not
but
one.
Fine, just listen.
But that's not true. A couple of years ago, if you'd have said 1,000 years ago.
Yeah, it was busy and that. And there was this bloke, who had a kid, and the kid was saying, Dad, you know, can I go and see, you know, Father Christmas in the grotto?
Yeah.
And he was like, oh, I don't want to join that queue, it's too big, right? And loads of the Father Christmases who was in the booth, they kept jacking it in because the queue was that big.
What do you mean loads of Father Christmas in the booth? What
because
booth?
They got through loads in the grotto, the Father Christmas and that, right? They couldn't act the pressure of the queues. The queues were massive for this grotto.
This is rubbish!
Right, so they come kept, on, come so they on, get yeah. getting through, like, loads of Father Christmases.
They just
like,
get walking
people, they kept saying, I can't handle this, you'll have to get a new one in, right?
Right, okay.
Anyway, so this fella, right, the kid kept asking every day, can we go in there? He said, no, look, the queue's big. Anyway, one day, the queue was suddenly a lot shorter. Right, because they got a new little Father Christmas fella.
I can't. I mean,
no,
can't,
right.
In the
right,
grotto.
Carl. If this Father Christmas turns out to be about 3 foot 6 and hairy.
So anyway, right. So he's going. Come on, then we'll join the queue. Right. So he joins the queue, and he's you know the queue's going down really fast. People are going in and out really quick. And he's going. How's he managing to do this? Right. And he sort of looks through the curtain. He can just see a little slight thing, and he can see the bloke who's like dressed up as Father Christmas. He's handing him out with his hands and his feet and that. Right. So they're going. No, look.
I'm
if
die.
You don't,
I'm going to die. You,
so
oh God.
Anyway, so
please don't interrupt the news, Rick.
Oh
I want to hear
God.
The news. Just
so he's queuing up, right? And he's going, oh, he's good, good on him. You know, he's got a new method of handing out the presents and that. Whilst he's queuing there, there's a little fella selling chestnuts. So he thinks, oh, I'll buy some of them, and you know, something to munch on whilst I'm in the queue and stuff.
Yeah.
And so anyway, he's queuing up. He's eating the chestnuts. Comes to his turn.
Yeah.
Right.
It's absolute rubbish.
What are you about?
It's absolute rubbish.
So
cut a long story short, you reckoned that they hired a chimp to hand out presents for Father Christmas.
And so he brought the chestnuts in and the monkey attacked him
well,
and
he went off, right? And he's going, why is it all going mad? And
you're absolutely talking rubbish.
There's a little fella that sat there with like a little beard on and that.
Yeah, you're talking rubbish. You're talking rubbish.
Well, it's not worth me carrying on then.
No, it's not worth me carrying on because again, it's absolutely rubbish. That didn't happen. There's no way they'd hire a chimp, and there's no way people would go. They noticed. They'd see it was a chimp.
Forget it.
They'd say it was absolute forget rubbish. If you want to find out more about Carl, what's the website address, Carl?
bbc.co.uk.
And I've drawn a little picture that you can win of Carl, and it really sums him up.
All right. See you later. Then. Right. Next week, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's coming on.